Little option play that time. Potts, another cutback. Oh, man, another cutback. He's going to go to the outside. Does he have enough horse?
He does.
And he does. Touchdown, Trayson Potts.
The Wildcats and some pressure as well on the quarterback.
Third down and four. Watkins, quick throw that time. Gets it out to his playmaker, Williams. Williams is going to pick up enough for the first down and then some. He's on his way. He's got one man to beat, and he's still on his feet. There he goes. He's at the 30, the 20, the 10, and he's in for a touchdown. Kick. Walker's going to field it on the fly at the 30-yard line.
Makes first
a first guy miss. Going to set up the wall. Here he goes. Gets to the outside. And he's got a couple of them. Marty Nuck and a guy around. How would you like to try to get around him? Elliot Walker's going to walk in. First down, so it brings up second and short. Kavanaugh up the middle. Nice trap play. Kavanaugh is going to kick it to the outside. Has a lot of running room. Still on his feet. He's at the 30, and he's just got some speed. Here comes Potts, left-hand side. He's going to kick it. Wow, what a shift. He's
going all the way.
He's all the way. How about that block? Motion out to the right. They're going to swing it to him. Hunter Webb gets a few blocks. Going to cut it across the air. There he goes. He's got the rail set up. And he gets to the first down. Still on his feet.
He's gone.
Hunter Webb with a touchdown.
Wow.
Touchdown.
Hey, what's going on? It's Jake and Ben over at Horsepower Harley-Davidson. We're out here on the sales floor checking out the pink tags and the pink balloons. Ben, tell them what's going on.
Right now on our pre-owned inventory, we have the pink tag sale going on.
What that means is that Horsepower Harley-Davidson will be donating to $25 to Catherine Kander Lundy Women's Breast Health Center right here in our backyard at Williamsport Divine Providence Hospital. Come on down and check out these big sales and big event, Horsepower Harley-Davidson, 1910 East 3rd Street.
So come out and see us.
Hi, welcome to Great Clips. Just walk right in, no appointment necessary. To save more time, download our free Great Clips app. Here at Great Clips, we have personalized haircut notes, so you'll leave here feeling like nothing less than a millionaire.
So come visit us today at the Loyal Plaza on the Golden Strip.
Get your head in the game here at Great Clips. It's going to be great.
Great Clips. It's going to be great.
Did you hear that? It sounds like great new deals at Cups, your vacuum center. We offer new and used vacuums from all of the best brands, including Kirby, Shark, Dyson, Electrolux, Oreck, Hoover, and many more. Got an old vacuum that needs repair? Trust that our service repair technician will get it working like new again. For bags, belts, filters, repairs, and sales, trust Cups Vacuum Center located at 1001 Washington Boulevard in Williamsport.
Hi, I'm Brian Cochran, owner and operator of Cochran Automotive and Towing. We're happy to sponsor Williamsport football game on PA Sports Live. We have complete towing roadside services from lockouts, fuel delivery, flat tires, and breakdowns. We all know accidents happen. When they do, request us. We can save you $75 on a city fee if you request us.
Yep. And Paul, there's a squib kick taken at the 25-yard line, and it's taken by one of the upbacks who ends up getting to the 40-yard line. So good opening field position for your Williamsport Millionaires. Hello, everyone. Jamie Spencer along with Paul McGinn here in Milford, Pennsylvania, right on the border of upstate New York and also New Jersey, as we had quite a bit of a road trip. And, Paul, we're doing the best we can doing the live presentation, but it might have some hiccups tonight. But, hey, what can you do? Welcome, bud.
Yeah, nice long trip up here, kind of in the middle of nowhere. Beautiful facility, though, and
gorgeous.
You said it, right in the corner of PA.
Homecoming. Twins to the right. Hankins, the quarterback, under center. Potts, the tailback, will get it here on first down. Off the left-hand side, picks up a nice 4 yards on the opening play of the game. And Potts, he didn't get a chance to really talk about him in the pregame because there was really no pregame. But tell us a little bit about the talented sophomore.
Yeah, Potts last year able to eclipse the 1,000-yard mark on the young season. And, man, this kid's talented. Going places for sure.
Second down and 7. 5 wide receivers here for Hankins. Empty backfield. It's going to take the quarterback draw up the middle. Tries to get to the outside. Great tackle that time. I believe that's number 38. And 38 was right in on the play. That's a big stop. Tough to bring him down. That's John Mangiola. He's a defensive end. No huddle.
Yeah, you like the up-tempo offense here to start. We are in a hostile environment here. Two very good teams, not only in District 2 6A, but across the state. Two very good teams, and you like the up-tempo here. Force any issue to start.
Three wide receivers will come closest to us. Paul Hankins from the gun. Going to go with the quick pass, and it's dropped that time by Wright, number 12. Maybe heard some footsteps, so that's a quick, uncharacteristic three and out there by the opening drive of the Williamsport Millionaires.
I tell you what, I had a chance to catch up with Wright there pregame on the field. Some limping around, has a hip flexor issue that may have come into play there with that catch. Saw some guys coming to hit him.
You look at him on the end, the sidelines, he is really hurt. Punting formation for Williamsport. Good snap. Kicks it away. Beautiful kick. End over end. It's going to be fielded at the 25-yard line. And great coverage as the young man is still on his feet. I don't know how he does not go down. Ends up getting to the 30-yard line. Well, Delaware Valley 4-2 on the season, but you look at their schedule, they play a lot of tough teams out here in the basically the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, hey, 4-2 with the record that they had that they had young season.
10:36 left to go here in the opening quarter. Beautiful, beautiful area. The leaves have already changed here in Milford, Pennsylvania, and they don't have any cell phone service. I'll get to that later. First play on scrimmage for Del Val goes right up the middle. And, Paul, we talked a lot on the three-and-a-half-hour trip. But, you know, you're telling me this very talented quarterback throws to a whole plethora of receivers. Also, they run the football well. They do it all. They're a good team.
Yeah, the Millionaire secondary, they have their work cut out for them this week, Spence. You mentioned quarterback Matthew Cavallaro. He's off to a phenomenal start this season. More on him in a second.
Second down in 8. Play action. Quarterback going to roll out, has some people open. It's thrown across the middle to number big, 87. Gets across the halfway mark, down inside Millionaire territory at the 44-yard line. On my program, that's Brendan Haney, 6'2", 260. How would you like to try to tackle that kid?
No, rocking number 87. Little glimpse of a Rob Gronkowski there as far as the size goes. I don't know about the speed or the talent. We'll see.
So first down here for the Delaware Valley Warriors on homecoming. Tailback give right up the middle, hit right at the line of scrimmage. And, Paulie, tell me a little bit about that Millionaire defense who's came a long way this year.
Yeah, Williamsport's D-line linebackers, they also face a tough test here today. You know, good running back here for Delaware Valley. The last couple weeks have kind of been a point of impact. These guys have really stepped it up.
Second down and long here for the Warriors. Tailback give again, crafty. Gets a nice push up the middle. As I'll tell you, that front five, and you throw in some of those big tight ends, they got a lot of big bodies in black shirts there. It's going to bring up a third down and 4 situation. 8:51 here in the opening quarter. Jamie Spencer, Paul McGinn, PA Sports Live, powered by the Web Weekly. There's also somebody else powering us, and maybe we'll get to that later. Secrets out. I'm not allowed to buy a Harley, but third down and 4. Motion. Going to go with the quick give up the middle, and the Ryan, he's still on his feet, has one man to beat, and he tripped up himself. Paul, we've seen that play a lot of times where the defense has struggled. That's just a kind of a counter, a draw. Guy runs right up the middle and picks up quite a few yards.
Yeah, listen, Millionaires can't afford to get off to a slow start this week. This Delaware Valley Warriors team, they're very physical at the offensive line. They got a running back, you just saw him, number 20, Orbiso, who is very capable of breaking off runs just like that.
Delaware Valley gets into the red zone. It'll be first and goal from the 9-yard line on the left hat. One wide receiver will come to us, backs are in the eye. Tailback gets the give, gets inside of the 5-yard line. Tough to see where he ended up, maybe to the 2, but a lot of big bodies, a lot of good power football, good blocking up top by the Delaware Valley Warriors.
Yeah, Orbiso again on the carry. You know, the junior, listen, he's only a junior, averaging over 5 yards per carry on the season, over 500 yards so far, several touchdowns as well. Kid can get it done.
Tight formation here for Delaware Valley. Second down and goal at the 2-yard line. Quick give up the middle, and the young man just walks in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Delaware Valley, number 20, Ryan Obisso. Kind of a slow start from the Williamsport defense, but again, hey, the defense has held serve all year round. It's been that offense that's kind of bailed them out a little bit. So
yeah, absolutely. And what we've seen so far this year in the games that you and I have done for the Williamsport Millionaires is a lot of times the defense feeds off of the offense. And so hopefully that again is the case here this week.
And there's a flag and a whistle before the attempt was taken. We'll see. As again, we are on the visitor side, Paul, so it looks like the officials will have their back to us all evening. False start against Delaware Valley. They'll move them back 5 yards and they will try it again. So we're going to try it again. Good hold and good snap. Kick is up. Kick is good. So 7:27 left to go here in the opening quarter. It's the Warriors 7, Williamsport Millionaire 0. And, Paul, it is what it is. Sometimes technology is your friend, and sometimes it's not. But we're going to do our best to try to buffer on through it or try to get through it. Everybody's blowing up my phone. Hey, you're skipping again. Hey, don't worry about it. PA Sports Live, maybe this week will just be PA Sports Replay.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's nothing wrong with that, okay? We know there's folks, your family and friend, that couldn't make the trip because of various reasons or whatever, that, excited to tune into the game. And you mentioned it, it's out of our hands, Sometimes we play where there's great service. Sometimes yep. We play like today with.
It's beautiful, don't get me wrong, yeah. But there's no cell phone.
There's a Walmart behind us, but other than that.
That's it. There's a Taco Bell that Paul hit up.
Yeah.
So 7:27, opening quarter, Warriors, they scored on their opening drive. AstroTurf, taken by the up man. That is number 20, Marty Clark. Going to try to get a couple of runs and is on his feet, gets across the 35-yard line where the Williamsport Millionaires will take over first and 10.
Yeah, time for the Millionaires offense to get some things going, okay?
Yep.
They kind of looked out of sync, out of whack a little bit there to start the game. But look for Coach Cruz and company to open up the playbook here and to find a way to get the ball to his playmakers. It's definitely going to happen.
Again, we were talking about this just moments ago. It's a weird time for a football game. Saturday afternoon at 4 o'clock, I thought that Delaware Valley didn't have any lights. More to that later. Hankins from the shotgun, all by him lonesome. 5 wide receivers again. Hankins, quick throw this time. Gets it out to Elliott Walker. Walker cuts it in string, and he's going to get the first down. And then some, just short of the 50-yard line midfield. Great play, Elliott Walker. They're finding ways to get that guy some touches.
Yeah, again, here we are, up-tempo offense, finding ways to get the ball in the hands of your playmakers. Elliott Walker, definitely one of them. Dual threat, all right, wide receiver, running the ball, you name it. The kid's got talent.
Shotgun formation again for Hankins. 2 sidecars. I don't know what that means, but all the broadcasters say it. Hankins going to go with the option, decides to keek it, and he is just met right at the line of scrimmage. Defensive end did a nice job just holding serve. Didn't get faked out at all by the fake pitch, and boom. So, 1-yard gain.
Now, with everything going on, people telling us, the streaming says it's offline,
yeah.
Buffering, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Maybe I missed a Potts run, but has he handled the ball yet? Has he handled it yet?
He has. First opening play of the game, got about 4 yards, but that's about it. We'll see if they go to him here.
Let these big guys eat in the trenches and get the ball to some playmakers.
Second down and 9. Here's Potts. Potts at the line of scrimmage is going to try to kick to the outside. Great defense that time by Delaware Valley. You can tell very well disciplined. The young corner there did his best he could, just kind of staying back and bringing them down.
Yeah, that's tough to do. Good job there by the junior, number 1, Dylan Kelly. Staying at home, holding containment, and a good open field tackle against, one of the state's premier backs at number 3, Trey Potts.
5:45 left to go in the first quarter. The Warriors are on top, 7-0. Jamie Spencer, Paul McGinn here in Delaware Valley, and there's a throw across the middle. Looks like it's going to bounce first. That's a good call. Hit the carpet first. The intended receiver was Jackson. He was open. Not a very good sharp throw there by number 22. Kind of a sluggish start for the Williamsport Millionaires, but there's lots of time left.
Hey, you mentioned it. You know, it's a Saturday afternoon, 4 o'clock game. It took 2.5, 3 hours probably on a bus to get here. Sluggish start, you know, is understandable, but, man, defense got to step it up here, get a stop.
Putting formation for Williamsport. Walker gets off a pretty decent kick, high kick, fair catch, and taken right at the 22-yard line. Paul, we didn't get a chance to talk about our new sponsor, but you got to hit them up. That was my best motorcycle.
I like it.
Nation.
I like
but
it.
You got to give some love out to the horsepower of Harley-Davidson. Yes, proud sponsor here at PA Sports Live. And, I'm looking forward to working with these folks here in the football season, also some basketball season. Stay tuned, folks. We're going to be releasing some of the schedule of the games. You think Paul and I are good calling this football stuff? Wait till you hear us call some basketball
yeah,
games.
Yeah, actually know what's going on there.
Amen.
After, you know.
526. Play action. Quarterback going to drop, and he throws it up in the air, and it is complete. Attended receiver that time, and catching the ball is C.J. Anderson. Great play fake, Paul. Totally sold everybody on the Williamsport defensive secondary, who's been pretty solid the whole year, just totally got fooled.
Hey, listen. This team, Delaware Valley Warriors, they are a perennial District 2 powerhouse. Get this.
Tough.
They have not had a losing season yet this decade. Okay? Consistency. That's great coaching. That's a decent talent pool. Quarterback there. Cavallaro, big reason why they're good this year.
First down. Going to try the swing pass. And there is a lot of running room. The young man is still on his feet. Sorry, I was looking at a few missed tackles there. Should have been a 4-yard loss. One missed arm tackle. Next thing you know, it's a 30-yard gain.
Yeah, shifty move there by the back out of the backfield after catching the ball. Number 25, Cam Dickey, had a chance to really light him up, but whiffed. I mean, you know, to be completely honest, whiffed on the tackle, and what could have been a 3-4-yard loss turns into a 30, 35-yard gain, and Millionaires backs against the end zone here again.
First and 10, ball's going to be spotted outside the 12-yard line. Play action. Going to throw Ross Debbins, run across, and it's thrown. Oh, and it's intercepted. Elliot Walker right at the goal line. Going to return it to the 10-yard line. Maybe that's the break that the Williamsport Millionaires needed, as Ross Debbins, you know, kind of made the quarterback throw it. It was tipped, and there was Walker, who made a great play. Hey. We haven't had an interception in a while. We might as well give some love out to Sanders Mortuary, proud sponsor of that interception. That did not sound well from the tongue, but I don't care regardless. That's what we need. Sorry for hitting you with so many rabbit punches.
That's some kidney shots there. I could barely talk after that. What did I say in the car ride?
I don't know. Oh. First and 10 for the Williamsport Millionaires, taking over after the turnover. Marty Clark is the lone tailback. Long count. Clark up the middle, trying to get something going, hits a man and runs him over, and I don't know, he's just trucking people.
Great job there. Number 7, Trevor Smith, also plays wide receiver on offense, holding on after getting ran over.
Hurry up offense again, second down and 5. And Clark right at the line of scrimmage that time. Wow, there were so many black shirts in the back row. There is nowhere to go. Going to maybe lose a yard on the play.
And I'm not sure what's going on here. I mean, I'm looking at Potts on the sideline with his helmet off. You know, I just, maybe he's gassed a little bit from the defensive side of things, chugging some water. But here's 3 straight plays, you know, with Marty in the backfield and Potts on the sideline.
3 wide receivers to the bottom of the screen. Hankins going to throw, and it's tipped right at the line of scrimmage, batted down, incomplete. So another 3 and out for the Williamsport Millionaires. That's 3 in a row there, Bub. Got to give a shout out to Fairfield Ford of Williamsport. Fairfield Ford, fair deals, fun guys, good guys. Give Charlie Day a call. Located 3600 West 4th Street, just outside, you know, kind of Williamsport there.
You butcher that Fairfield for fair deals almost every week, but I love it. It's great.
And decent kick that time. Fair caught right at the 39-yard line. As Del Val, so far so good. Luckily, the Millionaires picked up that interception, but so far they have totally dominated the game.
And you mentioned it, three straight three and outs. And
crazy.
I don't even know if that's happened all season.
Not all season,
last
but I can
against...
definitely, when we were calling some games on the radio, that happened a lot. New regime.
Last week they scored on all eight of their possessions.
Yeah,
different
crazy.
Ball game here. Del Val is a much different team, too.
First down and 10. Two wide receivers to the right. We're going to go with the rollout by the quarterback. Going to throw. Quarterback comes back and is batted down. They're going to say it's an incomplete pass. Nice job by that Dickey, kind of redeeming himself there. Just batted the ball away right after the catch.
Absolutely. I was hoping maybe the refs were going to call that a catch, and because the receiver
fumble,
did
yes.
try to, you know, make a move after the catch, and I don't know, maybe he just didn't have it at all.
3:47 left to go here in the first quarter. The Delaware Valley Warriors are on top, 7-0. Paul McGinn, Jamie Spencer, we're here like a long ways away. Quick rub up the middle, and he's got some running room. He's going to get in the secondary and more. He's got one man to beat, dives for the end zone. No, he's going to step out of bounds right at the 5-yard line. And that was a quick, just little dive, reverse play. Number one, Dylan Kelly, 5'8", 155, speedster, got to the edge and took it there from there.
Yeah, and, you know, in my prep this week, I could be saying this wrong, but in my prep this week, I believe Dylan Kelly, the wide receiver, is actually the second leading rusher on this
yes.
team, probably because of plays like that.
Got a nice chunk of change that time. Be first and goal again for Del Val. The second time they've been in the red zone, or I'm sorry, third time. One time they, and it looks like Del Val's going to go ahead and take a quick timeout, and we'll quick timeout as well. We're going to go ahead and talk to, you know what? Hey, I'm all about getting a good haircut. I need a place to go.
Get your head in the game.
Hi, welcome to Great Clips. Just walk right in, no appointment necessary. To save more time, download our free Great Clips app. Here at Great Clips, we have personalized haircut notes, so you'll leave here feeling like nothing less than a millionaire.
So come visit us today at the Loyal Plaza on the Golden Strip.
Get your head in the game here at Great Clips. It's going to be great.
Hey, what's going on? It's Jake and Ben over at Horsepower Harley-Davidson. We're out here on the sales floor checking out the pink tags and the pink balloons. Ben, tell them what's going on.
Right now on our pre-owned inventory, we have the pink tag sale going on.
What that means is that Horsepower Harley-Davidson will be donating to $25 to Catherine Kander Lundy Women's Breast Health Center right here in our backyard at Williamsport Divine Providence Hospital. Come on down and check out these big sales and big event. Horsepower Harley-Davidson, 1910 East 3rd Street.
So come out and see us.
Yeah, welcome back. Jamie Spencer along with Paul McGinn here in Milford, Pennsylvania. First and goal for Delaware Valley. Going to go with the tailback give right up the middle. Fights his way to the goal line. Going to be just short. You heard from our newest sponsors, Haircuts and Harleys. What else can you go with?
Hey, get a sharp new haircut, look sharp, and then go visit our friends down there at Horsepower Harley-Davidson, selling brand new and used bikes. They got something for everyone there.
You like that tagline. Something for everyone.
Speaking of taglines, how about that commercial for Great Clips I was in? Get your head in the game.
I love it. Hurry up, going to go with the tailback again. He's going to get to the end zone. Touchdown, Delaware Valley. They will take a 13-0 lead, 2:53. Left to go in the first quarter. Williamsport looks a little flat there, big guy, defensively and especially on the offensive end.
Hey, it's the same old story here, okay? Starting out flat. You know, I know Coach Cruz and company and these guys, they have a lot of pride. They have a lot of talent. This game's far from over. There's a lot of time left in the game, you know, but we got to get things turned around quick. And they got the fake on the extra point.
Marty Clark.
Marty Clark.
Wrestles him down.
Oh, boy. Good job there by Marty Clark to not overcommit or just kind of fall asleep on what's typically a usual point after attempt. And on the attack there defensively, and like you said, wrestled the runner down. That point there could prove to be, you know, come back to bite Del Valle in the proverbial tail.
Yeah, just because we're not live doesn't mean that, you got to watch your P's and Q's. Speaking of P's and Q's, let's give a little love to Plumbing and Heating.
Sampson.
Plumbing and Heating. No job too big or too small. Give them a call, Brian Sampson. He'll take great care of you. 570-419-8006. Sorry, Paul, in between conversations, I was just responding. Yeah, yes, we're aware. Sorry. Yeah. Thank you. 2:53 left to go in the first quarter. It's been all Del Valle. 13-0. Williamsport, 9 plays. Haven't done anything. 3 and outs. Let's see if they can find some mojo.
Hey, Williamsport off to their best season since 2002. Not off to their best start here today.
And here's a return this time. Marty Clark. Marty Clark gets it to about the 45. Make that the 47-yard line. So maybe that's the little height they needed. I needed something too.
Yeah, good job there. Marty Clark playing the up back in the kickoff return. Good job to put the Millionaires in good field position to start. And we do have to say thank you to one of our main sponsors here this year, PA Sports Live, is the Fisher Insurance Agency. Jerry Fisher celebrating their 50th anniversary in the Williamsport area, being a premier insurance business.
First and 10 for the Williamsport Millionaires. Quarterback Hankins is in the pistol. Potts back in there. It's going to be his tailback. Gets the give right up the middle. Gets to the outside. There he is. Gets in the end zone. Touchdown, baby. Touchdown. Tracing Potts, and that brings the Williamsport faithful to their feet. That is a Park Pizza touchdown. Love it. And did Tracing just point to us?
He did just point to us. That's right. Did just point to us. And, hey, Coach Cruz has some bunnies down there, man. Celebrating a little bit with his star running back, Tracing Potts.
I wasn't worried about Coach Cruz. I was worried about Tracing. Don't hurt your best player. Nah, that's what the Williamsport Millionaires needed. Touchdown.
Absolutely. I mean, the kid just, he gets
makes
it.
Plays.
You can't coach vision. You can't coach speed. You can't coach burst. The kid has it all.
Girardi's point after is good. So just like that, Williamsport gets on the scoreboard with your score. 2:37 left to go in the first quarter. Warriors 13. Williamsport 7.
Hey guys, we've had a great time doing the games of the week so far on webweeklylive.com. I'm Gary Crispin here with a sponsor that we've got to give a shout out to, Cubs Vacuum Center here on Washington Boulevard here a lot of years, and they're one of the main folks that have really helped us get the streaming going on WebWeekly Live and, of course, on PA Sports. We want to thank them. Any vacuum need you need, these are the experts who can help you every step of the way. Stick around. We've got more coming up. Great games this season with a game of the week on WebWeeklyLive.com and sponsored in part by Cubs Vacuum Center.
And welcome back here, Delaware Valley High School, here in beautiful Milford, Pennsylvania. I don't know if it's Milford. It doesn't really matter, to tell you the honest truth. The leaves have already changed up here. We are extreme northeastern portion of Pennsylvania. Short kick again. Taken by the up man. He's going to try to get to the outsides, get some good blocks, and just ran a long ways to only get 4 yards on that return. Number 44 is, I believe that
Keogh
is...
Johnson.
Yeah.
Yeah, plays a big role on the defensive side of things. I think leads the team in sacks so far this year and making a big contribution there. Big hit in special teams.
So we'll see if the Millionaire defense kind of redeem themselves. Delaware Valley, quick... running back up the middle, picks up a block, gets in the secondary. He's been doing that a lot. He is very, very good. That's number 20. Number 20 is Ryan Obison, and kid's crafty.
Yeah, Orbiso is crafty. I mean, listen, it's totally different than kind of what we're used to watching with Potts and Clark. Kind of herky-jerky, if you ask me.
Not
but
smooth at
no.
all. Yes.
But it's efficient.
Gets the job done. Wow. The kid's running very well here. Two wide receivers will go to the bottom of the screen. Quarterback is in the gun. Drops back, got all the time in the world, throws it deep, has a man open, and there is a penalty flag. It looks like it's going to be a hold against the Williamsport defense. Marcus Simmons, number 21, the youngster, trying to cover.
Looked like Marcus lost his footing a little bit, maybe got turned around, and I think kind of reached out and held there the wide receiver. Not sure if the ball was even catchable, but it may have been, and, you know, rather take a penalty than a touchdown, huh?
In high school, the beautiful thing is it's just a 15-yard penalty. They don't do the actual spot of the foul.
Yeah.
And so maybe Marcus, you know, using good judgment, got beat, held him. Hey, didn't give up a touchdown, like you said. 1:57 left to go in the opening quarter. Del Valle has looked very impressive early, Paul. They're up 13-7. Got to give a little love out to the Gerio Insurance Agency, also Real Estate Excel. They took good care of Paul and I. Two wide receivers will go to the bottom of the screen. Quick give up the middle by the young man, and that time he's brought down in a hurry.
Yeah, Jalen Jackson in on the tackle, shooting the gap there. And I believe Nathan Welch also in on the tackle, the team leader in tackles so far this year.
And we have a injury on the field. Looks like one of the Del Valle offensive linemen, he's going to get up under his own power. That's good to see. And we're going to go ahead and kick it to a commercial. Take a little break. Let's hear more from Cochran. Nah, never mind. Yeah, we're going to stay here. .135 left to go in the opening quarter. I wish I can just tell everybody, look, it's not my I'm sorry.
Put a disclaimer out on Facebook.
I'm trying. In between plays. Quarterback rolls out, throws, has a man open. Incomplete, thrown a little high. Good coverage that time by number 24. 24 is Jonah Nicholas.
The Warriors quarterback here, we mentioned, Matthew Cavallaro, is a senior. He's completed 69 of 114 passes coming into the year, so he's very efficient. All right, thrown for almost 1,200 yards, 11 touchdowns, so only 4 interceptions. I mean, this guy's got the total package. He could beat you on the ground with his feet if he has to. And one thing that I've noticed so far in this game here is they roll him out a lot, and they look for the cross pattern with a tight end or a wide receiver from the weak side.
Brings up a big third down and 9. And he's going to be knocked down. He's going to be short. Be interested to see what Del Valle actually does here, Paul, because they're kind of in that in-between range, maybe a little bit too long for a field goal, as it looks like they will go ahead and go for it. Fourth down, and we'll call it 2. Fourth down, they're going to go with a full house backfield. Run up the middle, and he gets some nice, and I'll tell you, that's tough. Once he gets his feet moving, he's going to be tough to bring down. Picks up the first down and then some. 37 seconds left to go in the first quarter here, Paul.
Yeah, you mentioned the full house backfield. Almost 2 extra lead blockers than what you typically would see, and, you know, kind of ran into one of his lead blockers, just pushed him over and got an extra 2 or 3 yards for the first down.
So the Williamsport Millionaire defense, obviously having a tough go of it. 13-7, last play here of the first quarter. Del Valle, and I take that back. There will be one more play. Looks like there was a false start up front. Move them back, maybe 5 yards. Bring up a first down and 15.
Yeah, I mentioned the Williamsport Millionaires here are, you know, here on the season so far, off to their best start, 6-0 since 2002.
Rolling, really playing well. Yeah, I appreciate some of the folks. I'll tell you, and I try to do a disclaimer on Facebook saying, hey, look, sometimes it doesn't. We are in the middle of nowhere. as it's going to bring up a the end of the first quarter. And, Paul, we're going to go ahead and take a quick timeout as well. We'll hear some more from Cochran.
Hi, I'm Brian Cochran, owner and operator of Cochran Automotive and Towing. We're happy to sponsor Williamsport Football Game on PA Sports Live. We have complete towing roadside services from lockouts, fuel delivery, flat tires, and breakdowns. We all know accidents happen. When they do, request us. We can save you $75 on a city fee if you request us.
Hankins, the give to Marty Clark. Marty Clark
boxes
it out to the outside.
He's going to bounce to the outside, has one man to meet.
He's
still on his
go.
Feet. There he goes. He's at the 10, at the 5. Touchdown, Marty Clark.
Hey,
welcome
check.
Back, Marty. There we go. First and 10 for the Williamsport Millionaires after the timeout. 4:18 left to go in the opening quarter. Marty Clark's going to get the give on the left-hand side. He's still on his feet. He gets to the first down marker. Still on his feet. Still, he's so hard to bring down. He is in for the touchdown. Now, welcome back. Jamie Spencer along with Paul McGinn. First play of the second quarter. Delaware Valley on top, 13-7. First and 15. Play action. Quarterback going to roll out. He's going to throw the back screen. Almost picked off. Great job by that Millionaire defensive line. Number 44, Keough, did a good job. Get up the front as there's another stoppage in play. We'll see what it is. Got to give a shout out to Susquehanna Marble and Granite, LLC, located there on Fox Drive, just right before the mall. Can't miss this. You just keep on rolling, and then you look on the left, there's all kinds of beautiful, gorgeous rock slabs. So second down and 15. Three wide receivers will go to the top of the screen where the quarterback will flush out to the right. Marty Clark just macked him. And, hey, quarterback, yeah, nice to meet you. That's number 20, Marty Clark.
Oh, that hurt. I was going to use this when Marty trucked someone running the ball, but, man, I hope the quarterback there, number 2, got the license plate of that truck that just hit him. Wow.
Not bad. I think the intentions was pretty good, but you on mile marker 165, like 4 hours ago,
yeah.
It sounded a lot better.
No, I liked it. Delivery was crisp and clean. On time, on target.
Third down and 15. Ball spotted on the 17-yard line. Quarterback back to pass, throws across the middle, complete, and he is going to walk into the end zone. Touchdown, Delaware Valley. Wow, the Warriors have came to play, my man.
Hey, I talked about it, you know, early on. This quarterback, he's legit. They also have three wide receivers that have 10-plus catches on the year, over 200 yards receiving on the year, 3-4 touchdowns each on the year. This team's loaded, okay? In the passing game, secondary has its work cut out for him, but we got to get pressure on the quarterback. That's the best way to stop a good passing game.
And there was some movement on that left-hand side again. Looks like they're going to move them back 5 yards. 11:44 left to go in the second quarter, like you said. Warriors 19, Millionaires 7. As Paul's phone continues to buzz, mine continues to buzz. Listen, hey, it is what it is. It's going to be a tape delay.
And there's nothing wrong with that.
No.
Nothing wrong with it. Give you an opportunity to check out the game.
I know. Relax.
And it'll be up as soon as this game's over.
Hopefully we'll have some good news by then. But right now it's kind of one of those, Del Valle looking to play. And they're a good quality opponent. 4-2 coming in. Like you said, they haven't had a losing season in the last 12 years. So this is a good team. Point after is up, and the point after is good, just barely. Looks like one of your line drive I don't know, wedge shots.
That was a stinger.
And we're going to go ahead and take a quick timeout. Let's hear from that new sponsor.
Hey, what's going on? It's Jake and Ben over at Horsepower Harley-Davidson. We're out here on the sales floor checking out the pink tags and the pink balloons. Ben, tell them what's going on.
Right now on our pre-owned inventory, we have the pink tag sale going on.
What that means is that Horsepower Harley-Davidson will be donating to $25 to Catherine Kander Lundy Women's Breast Health Center right here in our backyard at Williamsport Divine Providence Hospital. Come on down and check out these big sales and big event, Horsepower Harley-Davidson, 1910 East 3rd Street.
So come out and see us.
Yeah, welcome back. PA Sports Live, powered by the Web Weekly, also powered right there by Harley Horsepower. Harley-Davidson right there on the Gold Strip.
Yeah, next to Ruby Tuesdays, I believe they have the pink tag sale going on this month of October where they're going to actually donate a part of the proceeds on all motorcycle sales to breast cancer awareness.
Beautiful thing. And again, I'm just trying to inform the people. Just leave me alone. And here's a short kick. 22-7. Delaware Valley on top. Young man number 11, that's Nathan Welch, finds his way to about the 40-yard line where Williamsport really needs to get things going a little bit. Last time they had the ball, Marcus Williams just got the ball and just ran right up the middle. I'd like to see it again.
Trayson Potts.
So everybody's got me flustered. Usually I don't get flustered when I check my phone and they say, hey, Spencer, you suck. But this time it's Spencer, you're off. Trayson Potts in the backfield with Hankins. Hankins kind of in a little bit of a pistol. And they're going to go with Potts. Potts up the middle, tries to jump, and ends up jumping for about 4 yards. That was interesting. As that, even the kid, when he jumps, it's fun to watch.
Hey, I tell you what, that's how you make something out of nothing, right? I know he's being recruited by Penn State, which I hope that's where he goes. That right there was reminiscent of a Saquon Barkley-type run. Wow.
Saquon Barkley had a good game. As Paul and I, we listened to the Penn State broadcast on the way up. Hankins going to roll out, going to throw, and it's completed to his wide receiver. Good enough for the first down. That's number 16, Tristan Connor. We talked about him on the way up. Very impressive young man. Good size, good hands.
Yeah,
solid.
And it's hard not to talk about him, okay? Because every single week we watch this team play, and Tristan Connor just does things well. He runs good routes. He's got big, strong hands. He catches the ball, and then he gets some yards after the catch. Great job. Good catch, Tristan Connor.
First and 10, twins to each side. Hankins, the quarterback, going to give it to Potts. Potts gets in the secondary, going to kick it to the another gear. Oh, my. That hurt my knee. That hurt my knee. He seriously just laterally, I don't even know how to explain it. That went just, wow, 90 degrees.
I have no idea how that guy's still walking after that. Wow.
That play was brought to you by Fairfield Ford and Williamsport. Wow, you better check the brakes on that one.
Good try. I don't think it was as good as my license plate.
No, that was awful. Two wide receivers go to the top of the screen, as it looks like the Millionaires did a good job of making the Delaware Valley Warriors jump offside.
There's. Make no mistake about it, this is by far the toughest opponent that Williamsport has played all year long.
And it's homecoming. There's some additional, and Del Valle's got a great field, and looks like we got a quick timeout, and we'll go ahead and take a timeout as well. As, you know what, I want to hear some more from Cochran.
Well, I'll tell you, a lot of great football games. You're seeing it at webweeklylive.com. And, of course, all the segments, our sports show and more. And thanks to the folks right behind us, Cochran's Automotive here in West 3rd Street. Big sponsor and folks that stand behind all the broadcasts on webweeklylive.com and PA Sports Live. We thank them for their support. Local folks, thank them when you see them, because it takes a lot to get these games on and, of course, streamed. And check it out on webweeklylive.com. Gary.
Did you hear that? It sounds like great new deals at Cups, your vacuum center. We offer new and used vacuums from all of the best brands, including Kirby, Shark, Dyson, Electrolux, Oreck, Hoover, and many more. Got an old vacuum that needs repair? Trust that our service repair technician will get it working like new again. For bags, belts, filters, repairs, and sales, trust Cups Vacuum Center located at 1001 Washington Boulevard in Williamsport.
Yeah, welcome back. Delaware Valley High School, Williamsport Millionaires trail Delaware Valley 20-7. Hankins under center. Potts is a tailback. He will get the ball. Going to kick it to the outside. There is a penalty flag. It looks like it's going to be a hold. Potts will get out of bounds. Will pick up the first down. But again, Paul, I think that's illegal use of the hands, which is holding. Moving him back.
And that's a tough call right there. Lineman doing his job, just sealing the edge. You know, maybe a, you know, what we would call in basketball a flop, if you will, there.
Yep.
But, hey, credit to the D lineman of the Warriors there. Got the ref to throw the hanky.
So that's going to bring them back, actually, only 5 yards because it's spot of the foul, which moves them back 10. First and 10, just like nothing started. As, now this guy is, okay.
Okay, coach, I hear you. Maybe I'll ask him.
Yeah, special thanks to our friends at RE/MAX Edge, especially Cherry Larson. Cherry has been in the game for a long, long time. She's got it all figured out. Give her a call if you have any questions about the for sale, the buying, the selling, the purchasing, you name it. 570-546-7791. Thank you, Cherry.
Hey, 50th anniversary again, the Fisher Agency. You know, at the Fisher Agency, you have the advantage of working with an agency that everyone has, you know, their continuing education. Everyone there is a licensed insurance agent. You get their expertise. You get their experience. That's why people choose Fisher Insurance Agency for 50 years.
It'll be first and 10, Williamsport, ball in Delaware Valley, 25-yard line.
You got to say a little more about horsepower Harley Davidson. If we're going to go back and back like a little rap concert or something.
Battling.
It's a battle. We're battling. Yeah, back to the game. Three wide receivers go to the top of the screens. Hankin is the quarterback. He's in the pistol. Drops back to pass, looking for somebody. Has some running room. Picks up a nice block that time by Potts. Scampers for the first down. Big hit that time by Trayson Potts.
Wow. You said it. What a lead block by Trey Potts. Look, the kid's not just some finesse running back. The kid just literally delivered the boom as a lead blocker. Wow.
So it's going to be first and goal for the Williamsport Millionaires. Hankins will be in the pistol, sends two wide receivers to the top of the screen. Talented Potts is a tailback, throws it outside. Walker. Still on his feet, tries to find his way inside. That guy, he's crafty as well, all the way to the 3 yard line. Nothing was there, but he made a play.
Hey, thoroughly impressed in pregame, down on the field. Walker putting on a show for the fans. One handed catches, you know, a lot of fun to watch.
And they're going to go with Potts real quick as, that looked a little too quick, it seemed, for the Williamsport Millionaires. As Delaware Valley tried to make a substitution, and I think maybe Hankins tried to speed that play up a little too fast. Didn't look good from the get-go.
Yeah, a broken play from the start. Lineman, I don't know, maybe a little tired. It's just Potts ran right into the back of his own lineman. And
third and goal from the 5 yard line. Hankins under center. Potts is the tailback. We're going to go with the delay as Hankins is going to tuck it. And he's hit hard. It's going to be short of the goal line. Fourth and goal right there at the goal line. And there is an injured player there on Del Val. I believe that's 87.
Yeah, that's what it looks like to me, Spence. 87.
And, he's banged up pretty good. So we're going to go ahead and give a little, we got to give some love out to our guy, Connor Cup. Here's a little more.
Check this out. Yeah.
This is Connor Cup, 11 years old, the son of Yancey Cup, owner of Cup's Vacuum Center, one of our proud sponsors. This young man is looking for local sponsorship to help with this upcoming 2017 race season. On the weekends, they travel 3 to 4 hours for racing, and cost is really expensive. So please, sponsor this kid. He will be coming to your local business soon.
Hi, welcome to Great Clips. Just walk right in, no appointment necessary. To save more time, download our free Great Clips app. Here at Great Clips, we have personalized haircut notes, so you'll leave here feeling like nothing less than a millionaire.
So come visit us today at the Loyal Plaza on the Golden Strip.
Get your head in the game here at Great Clips. It's going to be great.
Great Clips.
Hey, what's going on? It's Jake and Ben over at Horsepower Harley-Davidson. We're out here on the sales floor checking out the pink tags and the pink balloons. Ben, tell them what's going on.
Right now on our pre-owned inventory, we have the pink tag sale going on.
What that means is that Horsepower Harley-Davidson will be donating to $25 to Catherine Kander Lundy Women's Breast Health Center right here in our backyard at Williamsport Divine Providence Hospital. Come on down and check out these big sales and big event. Horsepower Harley-Davidson, 1910 East 3rd Street.
So come out and see us.
Fourth and goal. Ball's at the 2-yard line. Hankins under center. They're going to go with Potts. Potts jumps, and it looks like he's going to get a touchdown. Runs for Millionaires. Just what we needed. And I don't know who the guy was saying, hey, don't go up the middle, but that was a brilliant play. Touchdown, Trayson Potts. His second of the game. 9:24 in the second quarter. We'll take it 20-13.
That's right, and that's the Park Pizza touchdown, baby.
Yum. As the coaching staff is really trying to fire up that defense, like, let's go, let's go. And, Paul, we said this last game in the drizzle, not much of a snap. I am very impressed of the folks from Williamsport who made the 3-hour trip.
Absolutely.
Here as Angelo Girardi go ahead and makes the extra play. 9:24 left to go here in the second quarter, 20-14. Williamsport trails, but, again, they're doing what they can to keep in the game. I'm having fun. Sorry I punched you earlier. I'm just a little disappointed that we couldn't go live. Let's hear a little more about some vacuums.
Did you hear that? It sounds like great new deals at Cups, your vacuum center. We offer new and used vacuums from all of the best brands, including Kirby, Shark, Dyson, Electrolux, Oreck, Hoover, and many more. Got an old vacuum that needs repair? Trust that our service repair technician will get it working like new again. For bags, belts, filters, repairs, and sales, trust Cups Vacuum Center located at 1001 Washington Boulevard in Williamsport.
Susquehanna Marble and Granite LLC, located there on Fox Drive. They do everything from vanities to countertops. They have the best looking guy who gets wet and yeah. Oh, well, that's enough. Yeah, special thanks to Susquehanna Marble and Granite. As the Williamsport Millionaires will kick things off. High kick, fielded at the 25-yard line. And young man is still running. He's got a couple of running ropes, and he is knocked out of bounds by number 20, Marty Clark, right at the midfield line, Paul.
Yeah, good hustle there by Marty. I tell you what, we were talking about Orbiso there as the running back for the Warriors and how herky-jerky he was and that type of thing. On that return right there, man, it took a while for Marty to catch up to him. The kid's got some wheels.
He does have some wheels.
But a big hit.
Huge hit. So Williamsport is on the defensive end. We'll see if they made some adjustments as Del Val will send two wide receivers to the bottom of the screen. Quarterback, very talented junior quarterback, is in the gun. Here's a quick give up the middle. Young man is just running and doing what he can. He picks up the first down, keeps those sticks moving. And you said it, man. Totally. He's herky-jerky, a little different, but he gets the job done, doesn't he?
It's effective running, that's for sure. And, you know, our offensive line got a lot of love this past week. You know, Tyler Anderson, Kurt Daneker, Chance Bauer, Eli Clary, the whole gang, you name them. They got a lot of love this week. And, man, this offensive line for the Warriors, they're tough.
And that time he's going to try, and he's still on his feet, does what he can to get back to the line of scrimmage, maybe even pick up a yard. There were some guys in the backfield had a chance to really wrap him up for a big game.
Yeah, I tell you what, big guy number 60, Dalton Kreiner had a chance for the tackle, but a big reason why that play didn't go very far. He broke up that play very early on, and man, big guy coming in there at you. That scared me a little bit.
Second down and 8. Quarterback give up the middle. Has running room again, and Dickey comes from his free safety spot. Big time hit. Short game. Brings up a 3rd down, and we'll call it 4.
Yeah, good tackle by Dickey. There was a lot of green after Dickey on that run that if he doesn't make that tackle, Orbisol might still be running. But instead, bring up a 3rd and about 4, we'll call it, huh?
Ball spotted on the 31-yard line right at midfield. Jamie Spencer along with Paul McGinn. We're here in Milford, Pennsylvania, where there is absolutely, positively no cell phone service. Full house backfield. They're going to go with the play fake. Has a man open. He's going to throw it deep, and it's up in the air, and Potts jumped a little too early. The ball's incomplete, thankfully, attended to number 48, big streaking tight end. They got some big bodies.
Boy, I tell you what, Nathan Welch, linebacker for the Millionaires, barreling down on the Warriors quarterback, forced him to get rid of that ball a little sooner than I think he wanted to, floated it up, and you mentioned it kind of was just a lollipop throw, and Potts mistimed it, but luckily was able to get his hand on it for the incomplete pass.
As the Williamsport faithful shaking, on the road, yeah, is shaking the stands. 4th down, going to throw across, and it's dropped. Dropped. Number 87, the big fellow who was shirking up a little bit over Brendan Heaney. Basically, he was wide open, would have had enough for the 1st down, but thankfully for you and me, he dropped it.
Yeah, so for the tight end there, he kind of stayed in for just a second or two, a little chip block, and then a delayed route. Was open, just dropped it. He probably took his eye off the ball and was trying to find Welch or Clark coming to hit him.
So that's a big change in possession right there.
Yes, sir.
Huge. Shotgun formation for Hankins. One wide receiver to the top, one to the bottom. Two running backs as they're going to send Walker in motion. And he's going to pitch it out to Walker in the little option play. Dances and gets himself a nice 8-yard gain. That 8-yard gain was brought to you by Sanders Mortuary, right there in the heart of Newberry.
Diamond Street.
A lot of good things going on there at Sanders, and they're going to take really good care for you.
Sure will.
Free consultations, look them up. And it looks like there's a stoppage in play. As this guy, he's always blowing his whistle and is just running.
It's always, I think, about the clock. This guy's the official timekeeper or okay. Something. Looking at his watch.
Nice.
We want to take a chance here to thank one of our newer sponsors, Great Clips. Go check them out in the Loyal Plaza on the Golden Strip.
Next to Payless.
Get your head in a game at Great Clips. It's going to be great. Hey, I didn't get paid to say that, but my son did get a free haircut.
Did he?
Yeah.
Logan did.
Logan got a free haircut. I was going to go there today, but, you know, I told you about how my day just was all out of whack. I couldn't get a haircut. Oh, man.
Yeah.
Great Clips. I'll be there Monday. I'm going to get a haircut.
And something important happened there because our fans are booing, and I wasn't paying attention because I was hearing about you. Something about the clock. Two wide receivers will go to the top of the screen. It is 2nd down and 3. Hankins, under center, going to give it to Potts. Potts tries to get, makes one guy miss, and bounces. That kid is so impressive. It's just amazing how everybody in the stadium, including guys like you and me, know that he's going to get the football. And somehow he makes the 1st guy, 2nd guy misses, bounces forward, gets a 1st down.
Yeah, it's almost as if we all have this expectation that as soon as he touches the ball, good things are going to happen.
Duh. 1st and 10, 2 wide receivers will go to the top. Hankins from the pistol. He's going to pull out. He's got some running room, but wisely throws it away. That was a smart decision. He was looking for Jackson streaking across. Kind of rolled out to the short side of the field. Didn't have much running room. Didn't have much action with the receivers. incomplete. And I'll shut up.
Listen, folks, 3-hour drive here, and that's the first time he's made any inclination of actually shutting up.
We ran out of talk things to talk about all the way up.
Good thing Penn State was on.
Amen. Second down in 10. Hankins will send two guys up top. Here comes Walker. Hankins going to keep. It's got some room.
Oh,
gets tripped
man.
Up. Oh, and that is too bad. And the young man, he knew it. That corner saved a touchdown. And actually, that corner is hurting. Looks like he fell awkwardly and did a nice job just tripping him up. And yeah. Hankins did a somersault. So there's a injury on the field. We'll go ahead and talk a little bit about Fairfield Ford, my man.
Yeah, Fairfield Ford.
Sorry to put you on the spot.
That's okay. No, that's all right. Yep. You know, new or pre-owned vehicle. Look, they're servicing Williamsport, Jersey Shore, Lock Haven, all of the surrounding areas. They'll take good care of all their customers. They took good care of you. Hit up our main man, Charlie Day, and his staff. Let them know what your needs are, and they'll take care of you.
Guy just looked at me. He was like, hey, are you guys doing this game live? And just said, nope. Tape delay. Yeah, let's talk a little bit about Sampson Plumbing and Heating. Okay, yes, we are not just pro Port. We're pro little Loyal Sock Lancers. Did you see what Sampson and Plumbing and Heating had their hands part of?
Yeah, him and Josh Butters.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Hulk. like, that was seriously superhero powers they put together. I don't know how to explain it, but it's just a huge fire pit.
Yeah, it was awesome, too. You know, they had a homecoming tailgate, I believe, before last night's game. Against who was it that they play? Warrior Run, I believe. We won't 50 nothing.
It was bad. It was bad. And that was a game that we were originally going to do, but then we found out that they had no cell phone service, so we decided not to do it.
This is Connor Cup, 11 years old, the son of Yancey Cup, owner of Cup's Vacuum Center, one of our proud sponsors. This young man is looking for local sponsorship to help with his upcoming 2017 race season. On the weekends, they travel 3 to 4 hours for racing, and cost is really expensive. So please, sponsor this kid. He will be coming to your local business soon.
Yeah, we got to get a shout out here to our main man, Yancey, and his son, Connor. Get this, 11 years old. He's doing things on bikes that, you know, the bike life. He's all about it, right? Bike life. Doing things that I would never even attempt to do, going off of ramps, and he's looking for sponsors for the upcoming season. Probably come into a business near you. I don't know. Maybe he's going to go down to Horsepower, check out one of their bikes. Who knows what's going on, but Connor Cup, man, big shout-out to the 11-year-old doing big things.
It's still a breaking the action, as I can't tell you enough how impressive this crowd is for a road game far away.
Someone must have wrote an article or something.
Three wide receivers to the top, and Potts somehow gets away. How is that guy still on his feet?
Keep going. Oh,
that was probably the most impressive 6-yard run I've seen in a long time. Didn't make one guy, two guys, three guys, five. I think he made about seven guys miss that time. I don't know. I was ready to say he was down for a loss.
Listen, I don't know about you, but, like, I'm not even shocked anymore.
No.
I'm not shocked. I already said, the kid touches the ball, you expect him to make things happen, and he doesn't disappoint.
6 minutes remaining here in the second quarter, Paul. Hankins from the pistol, three wide receivers closest to you. Long count. Going to go with the quick toss. Gets it out to Walker. Picks up a nice block, and he's going to pick up the first down. And there's a fumble on the play. The ball is still alive, and they're going to talk it over. But it looks like no official word. They're going to give it to Delval as Walker's banged up a little bit.
Yeah, I believe it was either number 7 or number 11 that was trailing the play. Okay, trailing the play, came from behind, and you know, that Peanut Tillman
made it
popular with the Chicago Bears. He just kind of came out and punched it. That's why the coaches, they teach you, you got to carry that ball high and tight. Don't get it away from your body, because that's exactly what happens.
So
right there.
Big turnover. Sorry to interrupt you, Paul. 5:39 left to go in the second quarter. The score 20-14, Del Valle. So Del Valle's defense picks up a big time turnover. Change in momentum. Here we go again. As going to run up the middle. The young man does a nice job keeping those legs
still
moving.
Still moving.
He's going to pick up the first down and then some, just on pure effort and pure heart. That kid, he can run the football.
Listen, there was probably 6, 7, 8 millionaire defenders there, plus 4 or 5 Warrior offensive linemen, and that pile just kept moving. You know, I was waiting for the ref to blow the whistle and call the play dead, and it just kept moving inch by inch by inch, and he picks up the first down. What an effort.
First and 10 for the Delaware Valley Warriors. Very impressive. 4-2 on the year.
Play action.
Going to throw. Finds a man wide open. Complete. Simmons on the stop. Not after. He picks up the first down. He's going to pick up 13. This team can move the football with the best of them.
Yeah. I mean, you have Dylan Kelly. You have Tyler Smith. You have Trevor Smith. These guys on the outside, these wide receivers, they're tough, man. They're playmakers. And this quarterback, you can't say it enough. He delivers the ball on time, on target, puts in a position where only his receiver can get it, but then gives him an opportunity to make a play after the catch.
Waynesport defense needs to stop here, Paul. I really believe this is important. If they can find a way to hold Del Valle before they get into the half, that would just be huge. Run up the middle. Number 20 again picks up the first down, just moving the chains relentlessly as the Millionaires just have no answer whatsoever for 20.
It's amazing how much momentum a team can get or give on turnovers. It's amazing.
There's a timeout on the field. It looks like the Williamsport Millionaires will take a timeout as the defense will talk to them. Let's hear a little more from Albright Studio. And special thanks to our man, Nick Fiorini, Albright Studios. I'll tell you, he takes amazing pushers. He even makes you and me look good.
That's hard to do.
Two wide receivers will go to the top as there's a delayed handoff again. As I can't say it, number 20, there's nothing special about him. Ryan Albison, we've said it, 5'9", 170, little methodical, but he just hits the hole hard, keeps his feet moving, and he picks up yards.
Yeah, this is exactly what you're taught to do from Pop Warner on up. Keep the legs moving. Fall forward. And it's exactly what the kid does.
4:06 left to go in the second quarter. Play action pass. Quarterback going to roll out. He's got some face. And he's knocked down for a big-time loss, as that will excite the fans. Seeing a lot of people hug each other. And sorry about that, Paul. I just get excited when the big fellow up front makes a big-time play. Give a huge shout out to number 11. That was Nathan Welch, defensive end with the big time stop.
Welch and Stebbins in on the tackle together. Wow.
Got to give a little love out there to Fisher Insurance Agency. We'll call that the sack. I'll think of something. 3:28. Clock continues to roll. Third down, and we'll call it 16. Quarterback going to throw it deep. Up in the air, and it is incomplete. Thank heavens they did the old seam. But Del Valle's got some impressive bodies. Number 5 was open. Number 7 was open against those little Williamsport Millionaires. Good job.
Yeah, and I'm not sure if these guys are twin brothers or what. Tyler Smith, Trevor Smith. Again, lack of spacing, good thing that helped us there. You know, two guys in the same spot. Good defense, though. Sophomore Marcus Simmons in on the coverage as well. Great job. Big time stop.
So Del Valle will be forced to kick. Good stop there. And John Astidano, number 59 with double knee braces. Probably by far the biggest punter we've seen. And he's got a good leg on him as Walker's going to let it bounce at the 10-yard line. And it takes a great bounce for Del Valle. And it's down all the way, probably at the 4-inch line. Wow. What a kick. And
I think you're being generous with 4-inch. Wow.
So scary situation right here for the Williamsport Millionaires. You don't want to do anything too clever. As there is a stoppage in the play, again, our buddy going to run over and talk to his head linesman. We'll see. Still no official word with Williamsport, as there is a flag on the field.
Personal foul, huh? Against Williamsport.
I didn't see that.
You know, the flag's thrown all the way up here at the 30-yard line. Not sure exactly what the...
I think maybe a couple of kids just pushing and shoving. I don't know what it is, but half a distance to the goal isn't going to do you much good here because it's already at the goal line. .304 left to go here in the second quarter. The Warriors of Delaware Valley are on top, 20-14. Williamsport has a challenge here. Hankins, look for him to just kind of give some room. Try to do the quick dive up the middle, under center. And he'll do the same thing as he gets a little bit of a surge, but not much. Wow. Good job by the Delaware Valley coaching staff, sticking a lot of bodies right up front.
And I get the play call because the room's always nice. As there's an injured player down the field.
Whew. And that actually will stop the clock as looks like he's just cramping up. I don't know how because it is kind of fall. But it is what it is. See some differently. And we're going to go ahead and take a timeout as well. Let's go ahead and hear more from the Harley-Davidson.
Horsepower.
Horsepower.
Hey, what's going on? It's Jake and Ben over at Horsepower Harley-Davidson. We're out here on the sales floor checking out the pink tags and the pink balloons. Ben, tell them what's going on.
Right now on our pre-owned inventory, we have the pink tag sale going on.
What that means is that Horsepower Harley-Davidson will be donating to $25 to Catherine Kander Lundy Women's Breast Health Center right here in our backyard at Williamsport Divine Providence Hospital. Come on down and check out these big sales and big event. Horsepower Harley-Davidson, 1910 East 3rd Street.
So come out and see us.
Yeah, give a special thanks again to Horsepower Harley-Davidson. The pink tag sale going on all this month. $25 donated to breast cancer awareness for every sale.
Marty Clark's going to get the give right up the middle. Picks up nothing, absolutely nothing. And it's 2:30 left to go here in the second quarter as they're just trying to get things rolling. Just trying to get it out of the end zone. Everybody, it's amazing. You're 6-0 doing some things right. Now all of a sudden everybody's a coach. Sorry.
I'm not talking to anyone in specific, right?
No.
All the coaches sitting in the bleachers in front of us.
Yeah, 2 minutes and counting. Hankins taking his time. He's going to send two wide receivers to the bottom of the screen, one wide out to the top. He's going to give it to Marty Clark. Marty Clark hit right at the line of scrimmage. And it's going to be a tough one. It looks like they are going to go ahead and punt the ball away. As Del Valle, very excited, calls a timeout. And we will go ahead and take a timeout with them as well. Let's talk a little bit about nice little trims.
Hi, welcome to Great Clips. Just walk right in, no appointment necessary. To save more time, download our free Great Clips app. Here at Great Clips, we have personalized haircut notes, so you'll leave here feeling like nothing less than a millionaire.
So come visit us today at the Loyal Plaza on the Golden Strip.
Get your head in the game here at Great Clips. It's going to be great.
Great Clips. It's going to be great.
Now, welcome back. PA Sports Live, powered by the Web Weekly. Jamie Spencer along with Paul McGinn. And Paul, a little break in the action. 1:44 left to go here in the second quarter. The Warriors are up 20-14. Had a great experience over there at Sports Clips.
Great Clips there in the Loyal Plaza on the Golden Strip. Look, did a great job on my son. You know, 4 years old is what he is. And, man, he was not shy, not bashful. Tons of compliments this week on how well his haircut looked. I'm going, actually, on Monday.
Walker is right on the back line of his end zone, and it's a muffed-up snap. He's going to try to get out, and he's going to be knocked out of bounds, and that is not good whatsoever. So Delaware Valley will take over first and goal at the 8-yard line as Walker just got a little too nervous there, Paul. Got that football, and just not what you need. It's almost worse than a turnover.
Yeah, and that's tough, though, all right? Your heels are on the back line. They're sending the house at you. You got guys coming at you every which way, and you got to get the ball off. And maybe a little bit of a bad snap, maybe a little bit of, nervousness. Luckily, was able to get it out of the end zone, prevent a touchdown or safety. Defense just has to come up and make a big stop here, force a field goal or a turnover.
1:36 left to go in the second quarter. Play clock right at 15. Running right up the middle. Young man gets to about the goal line. He's going to be short at the one as doesn't look like Del Valle is in any hurry whatsoever. Second down and short. 1:10 and counting. Again, Paul, they didn't wind the play clock until now. So Del Valle's going to take their time. They're going to go with that full house backfield. Run right up the middle. Hit at the line of scrimmage. He's good. Touchdown, Delaware Valley. Makes the score 26-14 and costly. Special teams play right before the half.
Yeah, man, I tell you what. A lot of people, they talk about offense, they talk about defense, but they forget about such an important role special teams plays in the game of football. We saw a punt downed at the half-yard line, and look what it did. Put millionaires all the way back. Here's the extra point. Botch snap. Look, going for it.
And it throws it in the air.
Wow.
And he finds
man.
A way to get in the end zone. Instead of tackling the young man and just didn't go his way.
How in the world does that happen? I'm at a loss for words, Spence.
Yeah, that was tough.
That was one of the ugliest two-point conversions I have ever seen. And it wasn't even by design. It was simply by luck, by whatever you want to call it. It should not have happened.
Yeah, no mojo right now for the Williamsport Millionaires as the score now is 28-14. Everybody's just a little shell-shocked, a little stumped. But here's the thing, Paul, you still have another second half of football, 57 seconds left. Hopefully they'll take care of the football, try to do some different things. It looks like Potts is trying to hide himself. Notice how he's on the up back.
Hey. I mean, there's 57 seconds left here in the first half. Williamsport still has two timeouts, so they possibly could make something happen here, hopefully, because Del Valle gets the ball to start the second half.
Yes.
With already a two-touchdown lead on the Millionaires.
Young man's going to kick it to Walker. Walker's going to return it right at the 20-yard line. He's going to try to get to the outside. Has some blockers up front.
Go!
Has some man. And he's going to get roughed up right at the 35 where the Williamsport Millionaires will take over first and 10.
Yeah, I think he just kind of got tangled up on his own feet or tripped up here on the AstroTurf, but decent return. 48 seconds to go here in the second quarter.
Dark. You know what I mean? I'm surprised they haven't turned the field lights
Maybe
on.
Maybe they don't have lights. I mean, I'm looking at them, but
if I might as well walk home.
Let's go, boys!
Hankins, he's going to send out five wide receivers here. Three to the top, two to the right. Good snap. Drops back to pass. Looking to throw. He's going to throw. He's got Potts open. Potts brings it to the inside. Picks up the first down inside Delaware Valley territory.
And Waynesport very smart and instinctively hustling to the line of scrimmage here.
42 seconds. Clock winds.
Let's go. Let's go.
Five wide receivers again. Hankins drops back. And he got a lot of guys throwing. And he's going to be caught. But again, there's going to be a hold, and that wasn't just a hold. That was more of a tackle.
Yeah, and that's unfortunate because Hankins and Simmons both make a great play, and I get it. You know, Williamsport fans, I'm myself and a Williamsport fan, upset with the call here, but I think that was, you know, pretty obvious.
They're not yelling at us, are they?
No, no.
Okay, good.
No.
I'm just kidding. So we had a hold against Williamsport Millionaires. 30 seconds as everybody's booing.
Probably when they watch the replay then on webweeklylive.com and pasportslive.com, they'll see like, oh, man, I just sounded like, you know. That was so obvious.
Yeah, the Williamsport Millionaires. Hey, pal, I think they just need to get into the half and kind of figure some things out. Hankins going to drop back, and that time he is going to get sacked for a loss. Number 29 is Anthony Skilla, as that stops the clock with 22 seconds left to go. As it looks like Del Valle might have called a timeout. Stop the clock. That's interesting. It's going to bring up a second down, and we'll call it 30. Wow. Wow, 23.
Hi, I'm Brian Cochran, owner and operator of Cochran Automotive and Towing. We're happy to sponsor Williamsport football game on PA Sports Live. We have complete towing roadside services from lockouts, fuel delivery, flat tires, and breakdowns. We all know accidents happen. When they do, request us. We can save you $75 on a city fee if you request us.
Did you hear that? It sounds like great new deals at Cups, your vacuum center. We offer new and used vacuums from all of the best brands, including Kirby, Shark, Dyson, Electrolux, Oreck, Hoover, and many more. Got an old vacuum that needs repair? Trust that our service repair technician will get it working like new again.
22 seconds left to go here in the second quarter. Jamie Spence along with Paul McGinn. Three wide receivers will go to the top, two to the bottom. Hankins going to drop way back. Hankins going to cuck it. And he is going to be short. But again, that's okay. Keep the clock moving. Let's get into halftime. Let's everybody calm down. All of a sudden, everybody has everything figured out. That's going to be the last play, Paul. And so with the score at the half, impressive. Delaware Valley came out on fire. They lead the Williamsport Millionaires 28-14. We're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be back here shortly.
Hey, this is John Powell from Williamsport School of Self-Defense at 1307 Park Ave in Williamsport, PA. I'm here to talk about a few guys that are going to be fighting on PA Cage Fights card at Montage Mountain this next Saturday, October 15th. First, we have Stefan Yaskowiak fighting at 135. It'll be his debut fight. He's awesome with his hands, good striker, he's got some wrestling background. Also, we have Cameron Chisholm Brungard, who will be fighting at 170. It'll be his first title fight at PA Cage Fight. Then we have Tyler Feist, who is fighting at 145. He already owns the title for PA Cage Fight, and he'll be defending it for his second time. Then we have our pro, Lewis Rumsey, who's got close to 40 fights under his belt. He's fighting for a title fight, title shot at a PAK's fight at 205. Then we have a up-and-coming pro, just signed his first pro contract. He'll be fighting on Bellator at 185 on November 4th, and that'll be in Connecticut at the Mohegan Sun. And then we also have Coach Scott Diggs, who is our jiu-jitsu instructor, and I'm going to pass it to him, and you can hear from the rest of them.
Here with two of our most talented pro fighters, Louis the Beast Rumsey, fighting against William Vincent next Saturday night at Montage Mountain. William Vincent is a talented fighter out of Michigan. Lou holds one victory over Mr. Vincent. We're looking to extend that to 2-0. If you haven't had the pleasure of watching Lou Rumsey fight, you need to get out and watch him. This young man moves like a 120-pound fighter, but he has the power of a 220-pound man. You've got to get eyes on him. Also here with debut professional fighter, Mark the Mangler Mangiardi. Mark is making his debut on the big stage at Bellator. You may be familiar with that name. Bellator MMA is one of the top promotions in the world. Mark will be fighting a very world-renowned wrestler from Penn State, Mr. Ed Ruth. If you have the opportunity to make it to Connecticut, this is one you don't want to miss.
Hi, my name is Tyler Feist. I'm currently training here at Williams Sports School of Self-Defense. Next Saturday night, PAKH Fight 26, I'll be defending my belt for the second time against Omar Kellum. Very strong opponent, but with all my training partners, I feel very confident. I put in my hours in, days in and out. I currently train in July. I went to Team Alpha Male for a week and a half, training there for 8 hours a day, training with some of the top UFC fighters out there. Looking very forward. They've helped me with my weight cut. They've helped me with my skills, techniques, you name it. I'm feeling very confident for this fight. Please come out, not just to support me, but for Lou, Stefan, Cam, everybody. We all need a support. You guys mean the world to us. However, if you guys cannot make it, that you can always go on the website, Go Fight Live. All right, right there, you can find us on the live streaming. All the support matters to us. Thank you.
Train hard on three. Fight easy on six. 1, 2, 3. Train hard. 4, 5, 6. Fight easy.
The tradition continues. Let your kids play where they teach quality basketball.
Players from Canton to Selinsgrove, State College to Hazleton, and Dunmore to Williamsport have joined forces to create a fun and competitive experience that coaches and parents rave about.
They will have fun. They will learn and develop. They will be part of a fraternity of hundreds of former standout players. If you want an experience program, it's Truth Basketball. If you want a safe program, it's Truth Basketball.
If you would like to volunteer, donate, or have a ball player between 4th and 12th grade, use the contact information below. We would love for you to join the family. Now, back to the game.
Give to Marty Clark. Marty Clark boxes it out to the outside.
Has one man to meet.
He's come
on his feet. There he goes. He's at the 10, at the 5. Touchdown, Marty Clark.
Hey,
welcome
check.
Back, Marty. There we go. First and 10 for the Williamsport Millionaires after the timeout. 4:18 left to go in the opening quarter. Marty Clark's going to get the give on the left-hand side. He's still on his feet. He gets to the first down marker. Still on his feet. Still, he's so hard to bring down. He is in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Marty Clark. He's going to throw across the middle. He's got a man open. That's Elliot Walker in stride. Walker is going to get close. Touchdown, Millionaires. Number 32, Elliot Walker. 26.5 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Williamsport all over Mifflin County, 48-10. And that time, great kick. Walker's going to field it on the fly at the 30-yard line.
Makes the first guy miss.
Going to set up the wall. Here he goes. Gets to
and
the
he's
outside.
Got blockers.
And he's got a couple of them. Marty Nuck and a guy around. How would you like to try to get around him? Elliot Walker's going to walk in. Touchdown, Williamsport Millionaires.
Teams he has seen in recent memory, and that's saying a lot, as they punted away. Millionaires have the dangerous Elliot Walker on the run at the 35-30, 25-20. Walker to the outside. Walker, touchdown! That long count Off the high snap, they go to Elliott Walker, and Walker in the mid 50, 45, 40, 35. Walker is going to outrun everybody. Touchdown, 57 yards. Elliott Walker, 85 yards. Down the middle, wide open. There's your tight end, Jackson, 40, 35. Jackson, the stutter step to the 25, to the 20, the 10. Jackson out of bounds at the 4-yard line.
Hankins, first and 10 from the gun. Potts, first time he's touched it in a while. He gets into the outside. He's going to kick it to another gear, Paul. There he goes. This is going to be YouTube time. YouTube time. YouTube time. There you go. Tracing Potts. Two wide receivers will go to the top of the screen. Potts is really deep. He's the tailback. He's getting the gig. Goes hard right up the middle. Finds a seam, then bounces to the outside. Still on his feet. Oh, my goodness, Paul. Touchdown. Touchdown, Tracing Potts.
The tradition continues. Let your kids play where they teach quality basketball.
Players from Canton to Selins Grove, State College to Hazleton, and Dunmore to Williamsport have joined forces to create a fun and competitive experience that coaches and parents rave about.
They will have fun. They will learn and develop. They will be part of a fraternity of hundreds of former standout players. If you want an experienced program, it's Truth Basketball. If you want a safe program, it's Truth Basketball.
If you would like to volunteer, donate, or have a ball player between 4th and 12th grade, use the contact information below. We would love for you to join the family. Now, back to the game.
This is Connor Cup, 11 years old, the son of Yancey Cup, owner of Cup's Vacuum Center, one of our proud sponsors. This young man is looking for local sponsorship to help with his upcoming 2017 race season. On the weekends, they travel 3 to 4 hours for racing, and cost is really expensive. So please, sponsor this kid. He will be coming to your local business soon.
Hey, what's going on? It's Jake and Ben over at Horsepower Harley-Davidson. We're out here on the sales floor checking out the pink tags and the pink balloons. Ben, tell them what's going on.
Right now on our pre-owned inventory, we have the pink tag sale going on.
What that means is that Horsepower Harley-Davidson will be donating to $25 to Catherine Kander Lundy Women's Breast Health Center right here in our backyard at Williamsport Divine Providence Hospital. Come on down and check out these big sales and big event. Horsepower Harley-Davidson, 1910 East 3rd Street.
So come out and see us.
Hey, this is John Powell from Williamsport School of Self-Defense at 1307 Park Ave in Williamsport, PA. I'm here to talk about a few guys that are going to be fighting on PA Cage Fights card at Montage Mountain this next Saturday, October 15th. First, we have Stefan Yaskoviak fighting at 135. It'll be his debut fight. He's awesome with his hands, good striker, he's got some wrestling background. Also, we have Cameron Chisholm Brungard, who will be fighting at 170. It'll be his first title fight at PA Cage Fight. And we have Tyler Feist, who is fighting at 145. He already owns the title for P.A. Cage fight, and he'll be defending it for his second time. Then we have our pro, Lewis Rumsey, who's got close to 40 fights under his belt. He's fighting for a title shot at a P.A. Cage fight at 205. Then we have a up-and-coming pro, just signed his first pro contract. He'll be fighting on Bellator at 185 on November 4th, and that'll be in Connecticut at the Mohegan Sun. And then we also have Coach Scott Diggs, who is our jiu-jitsu instructor, and I'm going to pass it to him, and you can hear from the rest of them.
Here with two of our most talented pro fighters, Lewis the Beast Rumsey, fighting against William Vincent next Saturday night at Montage Mountain. William Vincent is a talented fighter out of Michigan. Lou holds one victory over Mr. Vincent. We're looking to extend that to 2-0. If you haven't had the pleasure of watching Lou Rumsey fight, you need to get out and watch him. This young man moves like a 120-pound fighter, but he has the power of a 220-pound man. You've got to get eyes on him. Also here with debut professional fighter Mark the Mangler Mangiardi. Mark is making his debut on the big stage at Bellator. You may be familiar with that name. Bellator MMA is one of the top promotions in the world. Mark will be fighting a very world-renowned wrestler from Penn State, Mr. Ed Ruth. If you have the opportunity to make it to Connecticut, this is one you don't want to miss.
Hi, my name is Tyler Feist. I am currently training here at Williamsport School of Self-Defense. Next Saturday night, P.A. Cage Fight 26, I will be defending my belt for the second time against Omar Kellum. Very strong opponent, but with all my training partners, I feel very confident. I put in my hours in, days in and out. I currently train in July. I went to Team Alpha Male for a week and a half, training there for 8 hours a day, training with some of the top UFC fighters out there. Looking very forward. They've helped me with my weight cut. They helped me with my skills, techniques, you name it. I'm feeling very confident for this fight. Please come out, not just to support me, but for Lou, Stefan, Cam, everybody. We all need a support. You guys mean the world to us. However, if you guys cannot make it, that you can always go on the website, Go Fight Live. All right, right there, you can find us on the live streaming. All the support matters to us. Thank you.
Train hard on three. Fight easy on six. 1, 2, 3. Train hard. 4, 5, 6.
Fight easy.
Hey y'all, this is Jennifer from PA Sports Live, powered by WebWeeklyLive.com. Guess what time it is? Football time. Are you ready for some football? I sure am. Every week brought to you by WebWeeklyLive.com, we are showing you games in full HD, better graphics, bigger production. You don't want to miss it. Every Friday at 7 o'clock. It's not only for just the random football fans. Parents, when your kids are playing on that field, guess what? You can pick that game up from your phone, your iPad, your laptop, never missing a beat.
Little option play that time. Pots, another cutback. Oh, man, another cutback. He's going to go to the outside. Does he have enough horse?
He does.
Touchdown, Trayson Pots. Kick. Walker's going to field it on the fly at the 30-yard line.
Makes the first guy miss.
Going to set up the wall. Here he goes. Gets to
and
the outside.
Blockers.
And he's got a couple of guys. Marty Nuck and a guy around. How would you like to try to get around him? Elliot Walker's going to walk in. Touchdown, Williamsport Millionaires. Here comes Potts, left-hand side. He's going to kick it. Wow, what a shift. He's all the way. How about that block?
So join me then. See you there every Friday, 7 o'clock.
Hey guys, we've had a great time doing the games of the week so far on WebWeeklyLive.com. I'm Gary Crispin here with a sponsor that we've got to give a shout out to, Cubs Vacuum Center here on Washington Boulevard here a lot of years, and they're one of the main folks that have really helped us get the streaming going on WebWeeklyLive and of course on PA Sports. We want to thank them. Any vacuum need you need, these are the experts who can help you every step of the way. Stick around. We've got more coming up. Great games this season with a game of the week on WebWeeklyLive.com and sponsored in part by Cups Vacuum.
Hi, I'm Brian Cochran, owner and operator of Cochran Automotive and Towing. We're happy to sponsor Williamsport football game on PA Sports Live. We have complete towing roadside services from lockouts, fuel delivery, flat tires, and breakdowns. We all know accidents happen. When they do, request us. We can save you $75 on a city fee if you request us.
Did you hear that? It sounds like great new deals at Cups, your vacuum center. We offer new and used vacuums from all of the best brands, including Kirby, Shark, Dyson, Electrolux, Oreck, Hoover, and many more. Got an old vacuum that needs repair? Trust that our service repair technician will get it working like new again. For bags, belts, filters, repairs, and sales, trust Cups Vacuum Center located at 1001 Washington Boulevard in Williamsport.
Hi, welcome to Great Clips. Just walk right in, no appointment necessary. To save more time, download our free Great Clips app. Here at Great Clips, we have personalized haircut notes, so you'll leave here feeling like nothing less than a millionaire. So come visit us today at the Loyal Plaza on the Golden Strip.
Get your head in the game here at Great Clips. It's going to be great.
Great Clips.
Hey, this is John Powell from Williamsport School of Self-Defense at 1307 Park Ave in Williamsport, PA. I'm here to talk about a few guys that are going to be fighting on PA Cage Fights card at Montage Mountain this next Saturday, October 15th. First, we have Stefan Yaskowiak fighting at 135. It'll be his debut fight. He's awesome with his hands, good striker, he's got some wrestling background. Also, we have Cameron Chisholm Brungard, who will be fighting at 170. It'll be his first title fight at PA Cage Fight. Then we have Tyler Feist, who is fighting at 145. He already owns the title for PA Cage Fight, and he'll be defending it for his second time. Then we have our pro, Lewis Rumsey, who's got close to 40 fights under his belt. He's fighting for a title shot at a PA Cage Fight at 205. Then we have a up-and-coming pro, just signed his first pro contract. He'll be fighting on Bellator at 185 on November 4th, and that'll be in Connecticut at the Mohegan Sun. And then we also have Coach Scott Diggs, who is our jiu-jitsu instructor, and I'm going to pass it to him, and you can hear from the rest of them.
Here with two of our most talented pro fighters, Lewis the Beast Rumsey, fighting against William Vincent next Saturday night at Montage Mountain. William Vincent is a talented fighter out of Michigan. Lou holds one victory over Mr. Vincent. We're looking to extend that to 2-0. If you haven't had the pleasure of watching Lou Rumsey fight, you need to get out and watch him. This young man moves like a 120-pound fighter, but he has the power of a 220-pound man. You've got to get eyes on him. Also here with debut professional fighter, Mark the Mangler Mangiardi. Mark is making his debut on the big stage at Bellator. You may be familiar with that name. Bellator MMA is one of the top promotions in the world. Mark will be fighting a very world-renowned wrestler from Penn State, Mr. Ed Ruth. If you have the opportunity to make it to Connecticut, this is one you don't want to miss.
Hi, my name's Tyler Feist. I'm currently training here at Williamsport School of Self-Defense. Next Saturday night, PA Cage Fight 26, I'll be defending my belt for the second time against Omar Kellum. Very strong opponent, but with all my training partners, I feel very confident. I put in my hours in, days in and out. I currently train in July. I went to Team Alpha Male for a week and a half, training there for 8 hours a day, training with some of the top UFC fighters out there. Looking very forward. They've helped me with my weight cut. They've helped me with my skills, techniques, you name it. I'm feeling very confident for this fight. Please come out, not just to support me, but for Lou, Stefan, Cam, everybody. We all need a support. You guys mean the world to us. However, if you guys cannot make it, that you can always go on the website, Go Fight Live. All right, right there, you can find us on the live streaming. All the support matters to us. Thank you.
Train hard on three. Fight easy on six. 1, 2, 3. Train hard. 4, 5, 6.
Fight easy.
What's that? Oh, we're on live? No, we're on tape delay. And welcome back to Delaware Valley High School. Life is good. Jamie Spencer along with Paul McGinn as we're getting ready to kick things off here for the third quarter. The Williamsport Millionaires trail 28-14. As Paul, it just doesn't, it wasn't their greatest half. But again, we got to give a lot of credit to the Delaware Valley team who came in and they were ready to play. Scored quick and scored often, and their defense played very well as well.
Yeah, very solid team, well-rounded. They do all the little things well. All right, that's why this is going to be such a great game. Don't count the Millionaires out, okay? We're only down two scores. Second time this year we've trailed at the half. It's not a big deal,
nope.
All right? Defense, come out, set the tone here on this first drive. Get a stop. Three and out would be great, okay? Three and out would be great. Get a stop. Get the ball back in the hands of some of our playmakers, and let's get this train back on the right track.
And we're fine. Here's the thing. Okay, you're 6-0, and then everybody's griping around. Okay, you guys are live. You know, it's just like, whoa, relax. People in the stands, great crowd here,
well-traveled,
but then all of a sudden everybody's back to, okay, I know everything. Hey, just calm down, like you said.
Yeah, what's Lee Corso say? Not so fast, my friend.
Not so fast, my friend. And this is a good team, as we know. And, again, it's a weird time of day. You're playing at 4 o'clock. It's now dinner time. You had to drive about 3 hours via bus. It's on a Saturday compared to a Friday. Long week to begin with. Lots going on. And, again, this team that you're playing is 4-2, and they're jacked up to play in front of a very impressive homecoming crowd. And, you know, a few mistakes cost the Williamsport Millionaires. They had the one bad snap, bad kick there, and, you know, turnover deep in their own territory. And next thing you know, you're down 14 points, but it's not the end of the game. This defense, Stan Paul, is so very important.
It is.
Got to find a way to get that ball back quick. And, you know, I've been impressed with this Delaware Valley team. They haven't buckled down. They haven't backed down whatsoever. Defensively, they're tough up front. And their guys, they also make some plays as well.
Yeah, they have playmakers, and all of them have made plays. Whether it's Obiso, whether it's, you know, the quarterback or any of the receivers, doesn't matter. They've made plays. So has Williamsport. We've just had a couple costly turnovers and put ourselves in some tough position. But here we are, second half.
And it's going to be a short kick to the running back who's going to have some running room as he's going to be dropped down. Nope, still on his feet, getting close to midfield. Those are the little plays that we're talking about. Instead of bringing him down right at the 30-yard line, next thing, he gets to midfield.
And again, I want to point this out and without coming across as being harsh.
Good luck.
But I talked about Delaware Valley. They do all the small things well, right?
They do.
So in the first half, we saw where we tried to hide Trayson Potts as an up back on a kickoff. They kicked away from him. Here, they hide Obiso as an up back for the pooch kick. But we kick it right to them. It's the small things like that. You know, the football IQ sometimes, you know, I'm not sure what goes on in their minds.
Backs are in the eye. They're going to go with Obso, and he is hit hard right at the line of scrimmage. And you saw this in the Shikellamy game as it looks like we got a late penalty flag as it's going to be interesting to see what happened. Some pushing and shoving, extracurricular activity. We'll see who's it against. Personal foul against Williamsport. You don't want to see that. I don't know if it was a late hit or whatever, but no explanation whatsoever to Coach Cruz, and you don't like to see that, especially when you're on the road. 15 yards just like that, Paul.
I mean, good tackle there, I believe, by number 54, Jameer Burgett, defensive lineman, a junior. They blow up the running play. They get the stop that they need, and then just some extracurricular, just shooting ourselves in the feet.
So it's actually a gain of 15. It's going to bring up a first down and 10. Ball spotted on the 37-yard line. 11:35 left to go in the third quarter. As they're going to go with number 11 right up the middle, and he is brought down. Short game that time. It's number 11, Tyler McGee. Haven't really called his name much.
No, Tyler coming in up from the free safety position there. Making the tackle. Excuse me, that's number 11, Nathan Welch. I think we were looking at the the wrong, right?
No, you are.
11-08. On the rush? I'm confused.
Yeah, you're so
number
confused.
11 on the tackle.
No, he was number 11 on the run. Stop. We're not live. Play action pass. He's going to roll out. Has a man open, and he's hit right as he throw. The ball came loose. Great play that time by number 24. Number 24 on Williamsport's roster, yes, is Jonah Nicholas. No, I had it right. You had it way wrong. Third down and long. Can't tell you enough how important this play is right here. Williamsport again, down 14. 28-14. Field lights are on.
Finally.
Why we played it for, who knows. It's not like you got anything else to do.
Oh, don't bring that up. Oh,
I'm sorry. Two wide receivers to the top. Quarterback going to roll out. Has some, throws it up in the air, and the ball is incomplete. They said he was out of bounds. He intercepted it. Great play that time by number 24. Is that Jonah Nicholas again? But it was out. No, I'm sorry. That's number 21, Marcus Simmons. Fourth down. Don't get too excited.
Hey, great coverage there. Great coverage there by Marcus Simmons to deflect the pass, intercept it, whatever you want to call it. Just to be there in perfect coverage to prevent the first down and the long ball for a touchdown. Good job.
Fourth down.
And nine.
Fourth and nine. It looks like Dale Val's going to go with it. Quarterback is under center. Two wide receivers to each side. Play action. Here comes Stebbins. Throws, and it's complete. Enough for the first down. Young man still on his feet, and he gets hit hard at the 20-yard line. But again, what composure by that young quarterback. We've said a lot of good things about number two, Matt Kever, whatever, but really delivered a bullet that time. What poise.
Yeah, Cavallaro.
That's better.
Steps up into the pocket, delivers a strike. You know, that's impressive because he threw that ball before the receiver was coming out of his break. So the anticipation, the timing was all there.
Yeah, good timing.
Williamsport was in man coverage. Marcus Simmons out there on an island, all on his own, single coverage, one-on-one, you name it. Just good defense, better offense.
Fourth and 10, you think they would maybe get a little more pressure there. It wasn't much. As they're going to go with the draw play up the middle, picks up four, maybe five, or maybe three. Got himself locked up early, so it's a second down in seven.
Yeah, Eli Clary and Nathan Welch combining on the tackle there. And pick up a four, like you said, there for the Warriors of Del Valle. Williamsport needs to step it up here.
Going with that big package as they're bringing in the tight ends. One wide receiver go to the top. One will go to the bottom. Backs are in the eye behind the quarterback, Cavallaro. Fullback give up the middle. Giving him a bone, picks up two, maybe three, brings up a third down in short ball, 9:23 in the third quarter. It is beautiful around here, and that's why they have no self-service, because it's gorgeous. Jamie Spencer, Paul McGinn, my man Ty, he's doing some filming for us. Third down and short, full house backfield. I've got to think of a name of this formation. Got to call it the Hammer. As they're going to go right up the middle. Met right at the line of scrimmage. Drop down for a loss as 54.
Burgett.
Jameer Burgett makes a nice play. Fourth down and four. We'll see if Del Valle continues to go for it.
I'd like to see here the cornerbacks, secondary, some press coverage.
Tight.
All right. Right up on the line of scrimmage just to disrupt this timing here. All right. Just to disrupt the timing on the pass. Of course, with the fourth and short here, look for the run again, but you got to bring the pressure. Watch for the quarterback keeper play action.
Fourth and four. Play action. Definitely great call. Has a man open. It is hit. Incomplete. They're going to call it. Great big time play by number three. Trayson Potts, wow.
Yeah,
play of the game so far.
It does not get any bigger than that.
Nope. great, perfect timing helmet right on the football.
Right on the football.
Good
causing
stuff.
The incomplete pass. It's time for the Williamsport offense. Like I said, get this train back on track.
Williamsport will take over. So I'll tell you what, the coaching staff's really getting those kids fired up. Potts is going to come out of the game. Marty Clark will step in. Great play by what a stud sophomore. Hankins will send two to the top, one to the bottom. Clark is the tailback. Hankins goes with Marty. Marty gets in the backfield, and he's going to pick up about nine. Big time running that time by the senior, former Loyal Sock Lancer.
Yeah, one of, I think, what, only six players to eclipse the 4,000-yard career rushing.
It's crazy, and he's still
mark.
Going. Still going. And he's had a slow year this year. Ran for 100 last week, but, man,
scored
what a weapon.
Scored in four straight games, too.
And good job by the Williamsport Millionaires. Staying focused. The hard count. Pick up 5 yards. That's going to move the first down. Special thanks to our good friends, the Girio family, Girio Insurance Agency, also Real Estate Excel. A proud sponsor of PA Sports Live, unlike some. Two wide receivers will go to the top. One will go to the bottom. That's Simmons, closest to us. Hankins, under center. Going to go with Marty Clark. Marty gets in the backfield. He's going to pick up a nice 6 or 7, maybe 8 yards, and really runs hard. He's a bull, as he's going to be replaced by the sophomore. Good series there. Second and four, even though the thing says third down. Hankins is in the pistol.
They got it switched around to second down.
Might have heard me. Going to pitch it to Potts, and Potts had nowhere to go. They sniffed that one out. You could tell a lot of folks, especially in the defensive secondary, said, hey, look, option, 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 and they sniffed that out. It's going to be a loss on the play.
Yeah, very rare do you see, you know, a Williamsport run, let alone a Potts run, go for a loss on the play like that. But you said it. They must have seen that play on film this week, and we're ready for it.
Five wide receivers into the game. Three to the top. That means two will come to the bottom. Hankins is in the shotgun all by himself. Going to go quick throw. Gets it out to Walker. Walker makes some people miss.
Go, baby.
He's got
go,
some
baby.
Green grass
go,
in front of him. It's not green grass. It's AstroTurf. Has one man to beat, and he is tripped
in.
Up.
Oh, he's in.
Right. Touchdown. Kind of a delayed reaction. You were going to go down there and punch that guy if he didn't set it.
I thought maybe he was looking touchdown. At his watch again and missed the ball and crossed the plane. What a play. Hankins. Nice little bubble screen out to Walker, and Walker takes it the distance to the house for the Park Pizza touchdown. And I'm pumped.
Yes, and I just gave you a hug. We talked about it at the halftime. Got to find a way to get your playmaker some plays, and they've responded. Girardi is up. Kick is good.
Let's go.
That's going to make it 28-21. 6:08 left to go in the third quarter. Now it's better. Now I just have to, and let's go ahead and we'll hear a little more from Connor Cup.
This is Connor Cup, 11 years old, the son of Yancey Cup, owner of Cup's Vacuum Center, one of our proud sponsors. This young man is looking for local sponsorship to help with his upcoming 2017 race season. On the weekends, they travel 3 to 4 hours for racing, and cost is really expensive. So please, sponsor this kid. He will be coming to your local business soon.
Yeah, welcome back, Delaware Valley. Now I'm feeling a little bit better. With that touchdown, that improves the score to 28-21. The Williamsport Millionaires are still trailing, but feeling good. Got to give some love to my man, Connor. Connor
pretty
doing
cool,
backflips with like motocross.
Yeah. Wish I could do some of those things when
no.
I was 11.
Yeah. So Williamsport found a way to respond. As Girardi's kick is more like a pooch kick. gives it to the up man at the 35-yard line, and he is brought down shortly after. So Del Val, who moved the ball opening possession of the third quarter pretty well, turnover on downs with a big-time play by Trayson Potts, knocking the ball down, and then all of a sudden Elliot Walker, he was horse-powered. Yeah. I didn't even see
That's
it.
That's right.
I didn't even see it on the screen.
That's right. Horsepower, Harley Davidson, baby. Proud sponsor, PA Sports Live.
6:04, third quarter, 28-21. First and 10. Two wide receivers will go to the top. There's a little bit of a shift in the tight end. And nice run up the middle. That's our guy, number Ryan Omison. Be interested to see Massey's column tomorrow to see how many rushes, how many yards the young man had. I don't know where Massey is, to tell you the honest truth. Paul and I, we had a sighting of the doctor.
Yeah, that's the only reason we went to Taco Bell is to see the good doctor.
And he was leaving. Second down, and we will call it 4. Ball's just shy of the 45-yard line of Del Val. And there's a run up the middle. Good job there by the defense as young man did not go down, but his forward progress was stopped. Third down.
Hey, we've seen it all year long where this millionaire defense has fed off of the momentum of the offense. These guys are picking it up. There's a pep in their step, all right? They're looking to put a hat on someone. And they're wrapping up at the point of impact, and, hey, let's get it going.
Third down in. Scoreboard says 3. I'm going to say 4. It looks like a long way.
And that was a generous spot, too, there, by the way, because they lost a couple yards in that play, not gained.
Got some good size. Straight out pass. Going to pump it. Going to throw it up in the air. Great defense again by Potts. Incomplete pass. I thought they were going to have him on the little pump fake. Kind of a drop and go, but no. Wall-to-wall coverage incomplete. Punting situation.
Yeah, got him. Tried to fool him here on a little slow go, right? A little slant and go. And I think the receiver lost his footing a little bit. But Potts, you know, was there on the coverage, perfect coverage, didn't get caught with his eyes in the backfield, and here we are. A big fourth down and 3 from the Warriors 45.
Again, the biggest kicker we've seen all season. Big number 59 finds a way to kick it. Walker with the fair catch.
Oh, he caught a fair catch.
Tackled, and here comes a penalty flag. Great play-by-play call.
Sorry, I forgot. I forgot I wasn't a fan.
Well, it's okay.
I was at a game last night, Spence. Okay, Montoursville and Southern Columbia. Montoursville, they were in the game. Okay, right. A couple turnovers hurt them, but it was weird being a spectator. I'm yelling at the refs, and
it's fun.
Here I was again, now yelling at a ref. He threw the flag though. He heard me.
So, 15-yard penalty, I believe.
And I apologize.
No, it's okay.
Not only did I cut you off, but, you know, your mom's going to be watching, you know, later on from the West Coast.
Yeah, not right now, but later.
Yeah, later on from the West Coast, and I might scare her or startle her a little bit.
So first and 10 for the Williamsport Millionaires. Two wide receivers will come to the top or go to the top. Two will come to the bottom. Hankins is in the pistol. With one man behind him, he is Trayson Potts. And going to go with the delayed give. No, it is a quarterback keeper as Hankins had nowhere to go. Got to give a lot of credit to this Delaware Valley defense. They are big. They are mean. They are fast. And they're good.
Yeah, very well coached, well disciplined. Everyone has a job to do, and they do it. All it takes is one little seam, though. Potts doesn't need much room, just a little window, and no, look out.
Two wideouts to the top of the screen. One to the bottom. Hankins under center. Long count. Hankins going to give it to Potts. Potts hit right at the line of scrimmage, and you don't see that too often. Going to lose maybe a yard. No gain. Third down and long situation here from the Williamsport Millionaires. 3:15 and counting here in the third quarter. 28-21. DelVal is on top. Hankins from the pistol. Hankins drops back to pass, throws, and it's hit right at, and it depends on the spot. Looks close. Man, I thought caught the ball up here a little bit. That might have been a little bit of a, can
yeah,
you say this?
Yeah, definitely closer to the 45. They mark him all the way down at the 42?
Wow.
That's 2 yards short at least.
Yeah, and it looks like they're going to take a timeout to talk a little bit about it as we'll go ahead and take them timeout. You know, let's go to a replay. Let's try this. This is a new thing that we're going to go with. Let's go ahead and try the replay. Let's still. Hankins drops back to pass, throws, and it's hit right at, and it depends on the spot. Looks close. Man, I and as you can see, the ball should be spotted closer to about the 41-yard line, right?
44. I think they have him at the 42. The ball was caught at the 44, and that's where the contact was. That's where his forward progression stopped, as you saw on the replay brought to you by Horsepower Harley-Davidson.
Hey, what's going on? It's Jake and Ben over at Horsepower Harley-Davidson. We're out here on the sales floor checking out the pink tags and the pink balloons. Ben, tell them what's going on.
Right now on our pre-owned inventory, we have the pink tag sale going on.
What that means is that Horsepower Harley-Davidson will be donating to $25 to Catherine Kander Lundy Women's Breast Health Center right here in our backyard at Williamsport Divine Providence Hospital. Come on down and check out these big sales and big event. Horsepower Harley-Davidson, 1910 East 3rd Street.
So come out and see us.
Progression was at the 44.
Yeah, you can't talk to people while we're doing it. Hey, welcome back. 2:33 left to go in the third quarter.
Talk to the coaches.
I know. Fourth and two. Terrible spot by the official. It is what it is. Two wide receivers will come to the bottom of the screen. Hankins going to go for it. And Hankins is going to roll out. He's got some time. Going to throw it deep, and it's
It's complete.
I thought he was going to tackle him. Wow. That was a gutsy play by Hankins as they're going to continue to go no huddle here. But a big pickup. Forget the 2 yards for the first down. They got about 40. Wow. Crazy. Maybe we'll see. We might have a replay for that one. Hankins, and that time a little too excited as it's going to slow him down. Let's go ahead and watch that replay real quick. Check. And Hankins is going to roll out. He's got some time. Going to throw it deep, and it's
It's complete. Caught. Ellen Rose loves it, too.
I thought he was going to tackle him. Great play. Gutsy call. I can imagine that they didn't say, hey, throw the ball on a difficult, but hey, it worked out. Move those chains. 5-yard penalty against the Williamsport Millionaires as they're going to move them back a little bit. First and 15, balls off the 40-yard line. 2:23 left to go in the third quarter. Hankins will send two wide receivers to the bottom. A wing is in there. That's Jackson. Taking his time. Going to go with Potts. Potts gets a kick. Tries to get close back to the original line of scrimmage. Maybe picks up five. Maybe picks up six. Second down and long. So Potts gets to the 35-yard line.
You know, Potts isn't a very short guy, but, man, when he runs, he stays low to the ground. I mean, that low center of gravity. And the kid's legs extremely strong and just his vision there to keep his balance and press forward to get that back to the original line of scrimmage. Great play.
150 and counting here in the third quarter. Williamsport again trails 28-21. And going to go with Walker on the reverse. Jet sweep. Going to try to get something. And, yes, definitely hold on to that ball. Great play that time by number one, Dylan Kelly. The far cornerback sniffed it out right away and made the stop. Made Walker come on in. Third down and long situation, Paul.
Yeah, third and six here. Ball's on the Warriors 31. We got a minute and 15 to go here in the third quarter. And big play, big spot here for the Millionaires offense.
Three wide receivers will go to the bottom. Hard count, and it looks like he snuck them off. So it's going to bring up a third down and one instead of a third and six. Big difference in your playbook.
Yeah, absolutely. That hard count here today has been very effective for Isaiah Hankins and this Millionaires offense. Good job, good discipline by the offensive line to, you know, not move or anything of that nature.
And kudos to that group who's got a lot of love. We walked in with the Andersons before the game started. And, you got to be happy for those guys who usually don't get that much love. Third down in short. Hankins under center. Potts is deep in the backfield. He'll get the give up the middle. Tries to dance around. He's going to try to get the first down. He gets across the 25. Which is all he needed to do. First down, Williamsport, Paul.
Yeah, Potts gets to the line of scrimmage, gives a little jump cut to the left, and was able to pick up a first down. I just demonstrated the jump cut because we got lots of space up here, and I get into it. Getting into it. Might have pulled a hammy, though.
Four wide receivers, first and 10. Hankins. And, yeah, you did hurt yourself.
I'm stretching.
Last play of the third quarter. Play clock at 5. Hankins going to throw it to one of his wideouts, and he picks up the first down. That is number 16, Tristan Connor. It's been pretty quiet, as that will be the final play of the third quarter. So, again, as Coach Paul puts up his fist, as that's going to mean something. Now, see all the cool kids, they put up four fingers, man. Fourth quarter. And we're going to go ahead and take a quick timeout again at the end of 3, 28-21. And we'll go ahead and stay here. What the heck? Beautiful scenery. The flaming fall foliage.
Yeah, got a mountain here to our right, right? Some cliffs, and it looks like, each year the Delaware Valley class of whatever year it might be somehow hikes up that mountain, maybe.
Yeah.
And then they paint the class year up on the mountain. Pretty dangerous, I gotta say, huh?
Yeah, that just
would not, you do it?
Not very smart. No, I wouldn't do it. But great game. A lot of fun. 28-21, fourth quarter here, pal. We're gonna keep it here. Second down and 3. Special thanks to those of you who are watching the replay on PA Sports Live or webweeklylive.com. Jamie Spencer along with Paul McGinn. Three wide receivers go to the top of the screen for Hankins. Hankins is under center. Marty Clark, he's in there. Gets the give right up the middle. Picks up a nice surge, but he's going to be well short of that first down. Brings up third and short. Del Val's big up front.
Tell you what, the nose guard there, number 61, Nick Haydu. He's listed as 6'2", 291. That's being generous, okay? He just reached out his right arm, and I've never seen anyone do this. He reached out one arm and grabbed Marty Clark and kept him there until he got...
Like to keep those chains moving, bub. See what happens.
On the last fourth and short play, they picked up, a big chunk it through the air. Let's see what they decide to go with here.
Hankins. Got to go quick. He's going to throw it up in the air. He's got a man, and it is...
Throw the flag!
And it looks like everybody wanted flag as totally face coverage. But again, that's a tough play call.
Yeah, and you hate to. I'm not sure with the play call there when you got probably the best duo in the state close to it. On a fourth and short, you go for a jump ball in the corner of the end zone. That's one of those things.
You're right. Yep, yep, as everybody again, but you don't put that on the official.
No.
You can't. Maybe it was, but again, who's the official's not going to make that call? Especially when he lives across from Delaware Valley High School, Homer. Del Valley will take over. Going to go with the big-time play, and he got a man streaking. There he goes. He's at the 30-yard line, tripped up there, and he's going to go in for a touchdown. Touchdown, Del Valle finds a way to answer real quick. You knew that play was coming, Paul. Unfortunately, Williamsport D did not. Yeah, got to find a way to kind of readjust. But again, 10:53 left to go in the fourth quarter. With that touchdown, the Warriors take a 34-21 lead as Dylan Kelly just, wow, he's fast.
Yeah. Whew. What else to say? I mean, what a big momentum shift in this game with 10:53 to go in the fourth.
A lot of time left. Point after. Good snap. Good hold. Good kick. Kick is up. Kick is good. 10:53 again. Left to go in the fourth quarter. The score, 35-21. The Warriors are on top.
Hey, it's gut check time here. All right, gut check time. Want to say a special thanks to one of our proud sponsors, Sanders Mortuary. They're on Diamond Street in Newberry. Listen, it's always better to be safe than sorry. Get in touch with them, free consultations. Get all your ducks in a row because you never know what's going to happen.
Ducks in the row, I like it a lot. Remax Edge, special thanks to Cherry Larson. Whether you're buying, selling, or just getting into the game, give Cherry a call. 570-546, and her number was on the screen. Now it's off. Fairfield Ford of Williamsport, another proud sponsor, PA Sports Live. Special thanks to Charlie Day and the folks. And might as well go with one more, the Gerio Insurance Agency. Real estate, Excel.
Yeah,
good people.
Any insurance, real estate needs, give them a call. Stop by and see them. They're on Market Street in Williamsport. They'll take great care of you.
Now, that's too bad. Big change of events as, there was a little bit of a questionable call. As, you can't say enough, 50 years of insurance at the Fisher Insurance Agency. Thank you, Jerry. But a questionable call, but got to give Del Valle some credit. Came out. Play action, found a streak right down the middle of the field. Touchdown. Here we are, just like at the half, down 14. Some late substitutions there by the Williamsport Millionaires. Del Valle, with that 14-point lead, will kick things away. Going to kick it deep this time. And that was number 8. G. Green on the return. Gets out to about the 22-yard line, Paul, where they'll take over first and 10.
So it'd be a fun stat to have or a fun thing to look up on the average score or the average time per scoring possession for the Millionaires, because they can score in bunches and they can score in a hurry.
Yes.
So what has to happen here is you have to – I know you're down 2 touchdowns, 14 points, but there's still – over 10 minutes left to go in this game. One play at a time, stay within character, and keep to your game plan.
35-21. Williamsport trails. Two wide receivers to the top. Potts gets the give. Still on his feet. Wow, give that young man some credit as he almost looks like a pretzel there as he's a little slow getting up. I don't blame him. It looked like his leg was kind of turned around a little bit. As he's going to limp on out. Marty Clark will check in. Hopefully Potts is all right. He looks okay, Paul. Ouch. Takes a lot of hits, man. Tough kid. scary to think he's only 15, 16 years old, man.
Yeah. Yeah, as he walks it off there on the sideline, looks like he'll be all right.
Five wide receivers for Hankins, who's in the gun. Low snap, and he's going to try to keep it. And he's got a man open. Throws, and it's complete to Elliott Walker. What a big-time play that time. We'll see if we can get it on a replay. Low snap. Usually, you're taught to just dive on it, okay, not to make something dumb out of this situation. And what's he do? Rolls out and finds a guy wide open. Big-time play again by number 32.
Yeah, heads-up play there by Hankins. And to have the you know, what's the word I'm looking for here?
Who knows? Third down, or I'm sorry, three wide receivers will come down to the bottom. As another low snap, nice hit. And it's Simmons who's knocked out of bounds after a gain of three. And let's go ahead and check out that replay. Five wide receivers for Hankins, who's in the gun. Low snap, and he's going to try to keep it. And he's got a man open. Throws, and it's complete to Elliott Walker. Yeah, welcome back. 9:35 here in the fourth quarter. Williamsport trails 35-21. Three wide receivers go to the top. Clark remains the tailback. He's next to Hankins in the gun. Hankins, quick throw, and it is dropped that time. Should be an incomplete pass. Took them a while to blow their whistles. That's your buddy with a nice Rolex. You like that one?
Something. I don't know if it's a Rolex or I don't know, but.
Always checking the clock. Hankins from the pistol, 9:30 to go in the game. Keep an eye on Jackson, who's down here by himself. As they had a couple of men open, and he's going to roll out. And it's complete to Walker. He's been their big-time retarget. I thought they had a man streaking down the sideline. He was open, but good heads-up decision that time by the quarterback. Took it easy.
Yeah, you can't say enough about 32 Elliott Walker. Was one of the primary running backs last year, mm-hmm. but with the addition of Marty Clark, he moved from backfield out as a wideout.
And also Potts emerging as a stud.
Yep,
yes.
Yep. And has become one of the area's leading wide receivers.
He is good. And looks like we got offsides on the defense again. You got to love it. Five free yards. Keep on moving those guys. Doing a great job, that front five, on those hard counts. Not flinching, not moving. Rumor has it they were all having breakfast this morning at 8 a.m. And I even said something really dumb, Paul. I said, okay, next week we're in and we'll pick up the tab.
We better be going to a buffet. Or
could
Denny,
you imagine?
Or so, I don't know.
Yeah. Two wide receivers to the top. One lone back to the left. Potts. And there's the ball is loose. And it looks like the Williamsport Millionaires hopefully got it back. Ooh. It was right in front of that one kid. Good thing he didn't get it.
Yeah, that would have been costly, to say the least.
No gain on first down. It's going to bring up second down and five. 9 minutes in counting here in the fourth quarter. 35-21. Del Valle on top. Four wide receivers in the game. Throws to Jackson.
Oh,
Jackson
nice
completes
move.
It. Gets to the outside. Gets to the pylon. In for a touchdown. Touchdown, Williamsport Millionaires. There's number 10. Touchdown, Jackson. And he gets a nice chest bump right there by Coach Cruz. Oh, man, I am hungry. It's almost Park Pizza time. It is Park Pizza touchdown time.
That's right. What a play. Low snap by the center. Hankins handles a snap, hits the tight end out in the flat, makes a spin move off of a tackle or would-be tackler, and finds his way to the pylon.
Girardi, kick is up. Kick is good. The kid's doing some nice jobs kicking. So with the score, 8:35 left to go in the fourth quarter. The Warriors are still on top, 35-28. Let's go ahead and check out a replay.
Yeah.
throws to Jackson. Oh, Jackson nice completes it, gets to the outside, gets to the pylon, in for a touchdown! Touchdown, Williamsport! And welcome back, PA Sports Live, 8:35 here in the fourth quarter. Jamie Spencer, along with Paul McGinn, here in Milford, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, that replay, you saw just exactly what I was talking about. Brought to you by Horsepower Harley-Davidson. But he was able to spin off a would-be tackler and have the presence of mind to, you know, get on it and get to the pylon for the Park Pizza touchdown.
35-28, like you said.
And you can't say enough about the Horsepower Harley-Davidson. Brand new sponsor here at PA Sports Live. Proud to be sponsor. They have the pink tag sale this month. The whole month of October, where they're going to donate $25 for breast cancer awareness for every purchase, I believe, of a used Harley-Davidson.
Girardi's going to go with a little bit of a cuff. Another exciting football game here on PA Sports Live.
Yeah, and again, just as we talked about gut check time for the offense, remaining in character, sticking to the game plan, the defense has to make a stop here. 8:35 to go in the game, only down 7. Del Valle with the ball near midfield, but big time stop here is needed.
Two wide receivers go to the top. Quarterback is going to go with the fullback give right in the middle, and he's just grabbed by Jackson. Says, "You, no, you cannot go anywhere."
Reminded me of that Mortal Kombat game I played as a kid.
Hey, get over here.
Finish him. Second down and 6.
I'm waiting all year to say that.
Me too. Get over. As wow, he got a lot of substitutions coming in. No, they're just calling out the plays. Quarterback has been very solid tonight. That's number 2, Matt. What's his last name again? Cap. Tight
Cavallaro.
Formation. Tight
Cavallaro.
Formation. Three wide receivers are in the game, but they're in a tight formation. Going to go with the quarterback swing, and he's on his feet, still on his feet. Man, that little guy is good. That's number 1, Dylan Kelly. That time he was the end around. Instead of going to the outside, cut it inside. Tough to bring down. Picks up the first down.
Yeah, good job by the defensive player on the outside to force him back into, like in basketball, right? Cut off the baseline, force him back in to help defense. Same concept there, forcing him back into the middle, but the wide receiver had the presence of mind on the rush to cut back up inside, saw a hole, little burst, was able to pick up the first down.
So Del Valle picks up the first down, like you said, Paul. 7:25 and counting. They are in no hurry. Get into the line of scrimmage. Backs are in the eye. Play action. Quarterback rolls out. Low throw. Incomplete. Attended that time for number 33, Ryan Jensik. Incomplete. Second down.
Yeah, a little extracurricular there on that play. Number 48 for the Warriors. In my opinion, a little cheap shot on 25, Dickey. No one in the stripes saw it, and that's unfortunate because that could have been a 15-yard penalty, moving them back and bringing up, you know, a 2nd and 25 instead of a 2nd and 10. But, hey, must have been looking at his watch.
Well done. Three wide receivers will come to the bottom. Actually, that's just 2. As I'm going to go with the tailback give right up the middle. And he is just basically untouched, gets into the secondary and then some. Wow. Wow. Just when you think you have them. Okay.
From our vantage point, it looked like he was just surrounded by everyone. It was going to be maybe a 1, 2, 3 yard gain. And all of a sudden he appears out of the mass for a large gain.
And the clock is running, even though it was a first down. As Paul, you and I were looking over there into the sunset. That's just beautiful, man. As go with the fullback if he's going to get to the line of scrimmage. There comes a late flag. We'll see where that is. There is a flag on the play. I'm going to put that on Instagram later.
Hashtag no filter needed.
Looks like it's going to be a face mask against the Williamsport Millionaires. I did not see that whatsoever. So that's another big penalty. Going to get them to about the, Paul, the 11-yard line.
Yeah, pretty close to it.
First down, Warriors.
And throws it up, and it is going to be a touchdown. Touchdown, Delaware Valley makes the score 41-28 as the clock continues to run.
You know, Coach Cruz here has a very valid point.
Yep.
As Delaware Valley broke the huddle with 12 men in the huddle, should have been a flag. That play shouldn't even have taken place, and instead, the ref again, maybe looking at his watch or whatever.
He is looking at a watch.
And it ends up a touchdown for the Warriors. Good grief. That's the first time I said that in ever.
So the clock says 6:15, but it's just been rolling for the last 40 minutes. And they still haven't recognized that.
Wow.
And here comes the point after. Kick is up. And the kick is good. And they still haven't put time back on the clock. I'm not kidding. Paul, that clock went down at least 30 seconds. So with 6:15, okay, thanks.
They just put three seconds back on the clock.
6:18 left to go here in the fourth quarter. Let's hear a little more from Great Clips.
Hi, welcome to Great Clips. Just walk right in, no appointment necessary. To save more time, download our free Great Clips app. Here at Great Clips, we have personalized haircut notes, so you'll leave here feeling like nothing less than a millionaire.
So come visit us today at the Loyal Plaza on the Golden Strip.
Get your head in the game here at Great Clips. It's going to be great.
Great Clips. It's going to be great.
Did you hear that? It sounds like great new deals at Cups, your vacuum center. We offer new and used vacuums from all of the best brands, including Kirby, Shark, Dyson, Electrolux, Oreck, Hoover, and many more. Got an old vacuum that needs repair? Trust that our service repair technician will get it working like new again. For bags, belts, filters, repairs, and sales, trust Cups Vacuum Center located at 1001 Washington Boulevard in Williamsport.
Yeah, welcome back, Delaware Valley High School, where the Warriors on homecoming have a 42-28 lead. 6:18 left to go here in the fourth quarter. There's a squib kick taken by one of the up backs, and he keeps on running, gets to about the 46-yard line. Well, the Millionaires will take over, and the Millionaires just got to block everything out. Okay, made a couple of, you know, gave up some plays, but let's go. We got to rebound.
Yeah, you pretty much got to get in, you know, your two-minute offense here. Try to score within 2 minutes. Put the ball in the, you know, hit pay dirt. And then get a stop on defense, okay? It's that simple. We have the firepower on offense. I mean, we scored 28 points. The problem is we've given up 42. And that's not all the defensive's fault.
Nope,
you know,
nope.
There's some special team errors there. There's been some turnovers by the offense that has put them, you know, put the defense in a terrible position. But, hey, it is what it is.
A lot of time left, too. 6:14 in the fourth quarter. Millionaires, they trail 14. Going to send two wide receivers to the top, two to the bottom. Potts going to run out for a pass play. Going to throw it up. He's got a man open. Man behind it. And it's incomplete right at the 5-yard line. Somehow, number 16, that is the boy, Tristan Conner. I wouldn't say he's the speediest guy on the team, but he found himself to get dark. Let's go ahead and check out the highlight. Two wide receivers to the top, two to the bottom. Potts. Going to run out for a pass play. Going to throw it up. He's got a man open. Man behind it. And it's first and goal for the Williamsport Millionaires. Two wide receivers to the bottom. One to the top. Potts is the tailback. Hankins might be calling in audible here, Paul. 5:50 left to go. End the fourth quarter. Hankins Going to run the option. It to Potts. Potts cuts it up. Cuts it into the end zone. Just what they needed, Paul McGinn. They found a way to score quickly. 5:39 left to go in the fourth quarter. That makes the score 42-34. Park Pizza.
You got to love it. Getting back to that pass play there to Tristan Connor, it looked like the Warriors were in a zone coverage. Ended up being miscommunication between the safety and the cornerback. They just let Connor run down the seam wide open for the big play.
That's a big kick right there. Big kick as Angelo Girardi finds a way to kick it through the uprights. Makes the score 42-35. Winsport still there. Crazy. Always finding a way to answer that offense, don't they?
You got to love it, too. The resiliency of this group, it starts, everything rises and falls on leadership. I'm a big believer in that. It starts with Coach Cruz and company. And what you find out here is what these guys are really made of. They're made of heart and hustle, determination, and here we go. Got a ball game, folks.
Well, I'll tell you, a lot of great football games. You're seeing at webweeklylive.com. And, of course, all the segments are sports show and more. And thanks to the folks right behind us, Cochran's Automotive here in West 3rd Street. Big sponsor and folks that stand behind all the broadcasts on WebWeeklyLive.com and PA Sports Live. We thank them for their support. Local folks, thank them when you see them because it takes a lot to get these games on and, of course, streamed. And check it out on WebWeeklyLive.com. Gary?
Let's hit a blackjack table.
And welcome back, PA Sports Live. 5:39 left to go in the fourth quarter. 42-35. Del Valle's on top, but the Williamsport Millionaires have found a way to answer. Girardi gonna kick it somewhat deep, taken at the 30-yard line as he is rustled down right at the 35. Big hits going on by the Williamsport Millionaires. Let's see if this defense can make a stop.
Hey. Time once again for this Millionaire defense to feed off the momentum of the offense. All right, I know there's been times when the offense has put them in bad position, but look, the offense got them right back in this game, and it's time for a big stop by this Millionaire D.
Yes, our fans are really getting into it.
Gotta love it.
And they should.
I'm feeding off the fans' energy.
Me too. I just need my funny bone, if that's possible, in this table. Quarterback will send two to the top, and they're going to go with the play action. Here comes Dickey.
Gets
it down. Loss. Sacked. Number 25. Dialed up the blitz. That's Cameron Dickey.
As I'm fist bumping fans and high-fiving everyone, let's go.
It keeps the clock moving. Loss of, we'll say, close to 10. Second down and 19. Balls at the 25-yard line. 5 minutes and counting left to go in the game. Possible in this table. Quarterback will send two to the top, and they're going to go with the play action. Here comes Dickey.
Gets it down.
Quarterback is in the shotgun. Straight back to pass. Plenty of time to throw. Throws across the middle. Incomplete. That's what they call great coverage. Dickey, number 25, was right there, Paul.
Yeah, nowhere really to go with the ball there. Smart decision by the quarterback there for the Warriors. Not forcing the issue. Brings up a third and long. And let's see what Del Valle is going to do here, what the coaching staff decides to do. Are they going to, one of those maybe halfback screens, maybe a draw play or something, just and allow their defense to come back out and get a stop? Or are they going to try to go for it? Let's see.
Little by little, I'll tell you, the Millionaires have really struggled at those inside zone plays. Here comes the pressure. Throws across the middle. It's complete.
Oh.
Still on his feet.
Oh, the ball's low! Dickey! Marty Clark
backs away. Williamsport will take over right at the... Oh, man, I wish I could send that to my friends.
Let's see the replay.
I'd love to see the replay.
Marty Clark with the stop, strips the ball out. Dickey with the recovery.
Dickey! Marty Clark! Yeah, we're still on. Big time turnover right there. Turn of events. First and 10. We're the Williamsport Millionaires right at midfield.
We got Daneker's mom down here with the cowbell. Get it going. I love it.
Three wide receivers will go to the top. Potts is the tailback behind. And we're going to go with the quick throw. Walker has some running room. Walker has the first down, gets knocked down after a pickup of 15. Good throw, safe throw there by Hankins.
I love it. I love it. Williamsport hustling to the line. Got the NASCAR package offense going on here, the no huddle. Look for a little play action maybe here on first down and a deep pass. Let's see what we can get.
4:20 and counting, fourth quarter. Again, Williamsport trails 42-35. Hankins, play action. Throws over the middle, has Potts open. Potts picks up the first down and more. Potts still on his feet inside the 20-yard line. Great play call. Great patience that time by Hankins. Really had some poise in the back.
I like it. And what that shows as we go to the replay here quick.
Williamsport trails 42-35. Hankins. Play action. Throws over the middle. Has Potts open. Potts picks up the first down. And first and 10, Williamsport. Hankins will send two wide receivers to the bottom of the screen. Potts, tailback, gets the give. Hit right at the line. Bounces to the outside. Touchdown, Trayson Potts.
That's what I'm talking about.
Woo!
Flag. Are you serious?
Flag is on the play. Looks like it's a hold against the Williamsport Millionaires. Did not see it whatsoever. What an exciting get. Hit right at the line. Bounces to the outside.
The hold was 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage?
Yeah.
Really?
Yep.
How's it 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage when he was stuffed at the line of scrimmage and then busted it out to the outside?
Wow, that's unbelievable, Paul. And obviously, everybody's just got to keep their cool. It's going to bring up a first and 25 ball at the 35. So instead of a game-tying touchdown, now we got a lot going on. Yeah, that's tough, but it is what it is. Those are the cards that you dealt. See what happens. Hankins from the pistol. Throws. Ball is tipped, still in the air, incomplete. Had a couple of mans open, really darted that bullet there.
Hi. Oh.
That'll bring up second and 25 for Williamsport. Ball to Delaware Valley 35.
Three wide receivers to the top of the screen. Hang in there. Come on, bud. I need you. Hankins going to throw. It's got a man open, complete for a short gain. Get some of that bogus yardage that we were assessed back. Third down, and we will call it 20.
Yeah, and Potts may have been a little banged up on that touchdown run. What an effort that was by the kid.
Unbelievable.
Words can't describe, you know, not only his style of play, but that play in particular. And so he was banged up a little bit. I think he's all right here. And good time out here, I think, by Coach Cruz. Time to kind of rally the troops here. All right, we got a third and long coming up. Want to make this manageable because you're definitely going to go for it on fourth down.
And I like that Coach Cruz is just kind of giving that officiating staff a Care Bear stare. And he has every right to do that. That was just, I don't understand it whatsoever.
I mean, there's been a couple of calls that were not made tonight that should have been made. In timely manners, all right?
Yep.
On two touchdowns on both ends of the field, calls should have been made, and then they take away touchdowns by making calls that probably should not have been made. And hey, that's the nature of the game. It happens, okay? I'm sure that's what Coach Brown and company here is telling his troops. Look, you got to learn to play through it, okay? You got to learn. There's going to be adversity. There's going to be teams that are going to, you know, be tough and they're going to stop us. There's going to be times we come into a hostile environment and it seems like the fans and the refs are against us. But look, just play football, calm down, make some plays, make some things happen, and let's see what they do here.
Third down and a country mile. Third down, and we'll call it 20. Ball's at the 30-yard line. Fourth quarter, 3:28 remaining in the football game. 42-35. Hankins has got five wide receivers. Three to the bottom of the screen. Hankins taking his time. Drops back to pass. Has all day to throw. Jumps over his lineman. He's going to have to keep it. Tries, gets to about there. And there's a personal foul penalty. Oh, we needed that one, Paul. We needed that one. Out of bounds. I'm surprised the guy even had the audacity or the he can't say it. Can you say balls on that to throw it?
If not, if we're on a tape delay tonight, we'll edit it out.
We're good. So now this is great. They're having a conversation. And if they change their minds here, oh, I might just go nuts. Should be.
So did they call a holding? Personal foul. On the Warriors, 15-yard penalty, and an automatic first down.
Beautiful. 3:18 left to go in the fourth quarter. 42-35. Williamsport Millionaires trail, but they are knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door.
Oh, I like it.
Thanks.
Well played.
I'm going to save that, and I'm going to clip that myself. Two wide receivers will go to the top of the screens. One wide out to the left. Seven on the play clock. They
run
better
the ball,
get going.
White. Run the ball, White.
Potts is the tailback. Quick throw. Walker gets tripped up, gets inside the 5-yard line. Short gain. Maybe picks up three, Paul. 3 minutes. Inside of 3 minutes, actually.
I like the play call there. We've had some success with the bubble screen to Walker.
You got to give it to your Thunder and Lightning, man. Give him a ball. He makes good things happen. Two wide receivers to the bottom. Going to run with the option.
Hankins
kept it. He's right there out there. Touchdown! 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 Isaiah Hankins scampers in from 4 yards as the Williamsport Millionaires have found a way to answer back. Angelo Girardi will kick.
And I believe that was a design play. The fake pitch to the outside and a quarterback draw right up the middle. Touchdown.
42-41. Here comes Girardi. Good snap, good hold. Kick is up. Kick is good. Give that kid a chest bump as well. He's been perfect on the evening.
Clutch.
That times it up. 42-42. And that's not my phone.
Yours is charging, bud.
Mine's charging.
Yours is charging.
Oh, what a great game. What a great comeback. Man, I can't wait to post some pictures on Instagram.
And I got people texting me, what's the score? What's
the
score?
I know. Same.
I tell them.
I need to tell you.
Well, I'll tell you, a lot of great football games. You're seeing it at webweeklylive.com. And, of course, all the segments, our sports show and more. And thanks to the folks right behind us, Cochran's Automotive here in West 3rd Street. Big sponsor and folks that stand behind all the broadcasts on WedWeeklyLive.com and PA Sports Live. We thank them for their support. Local folks, thank them when you see them because it takes a lot to get these games on and, of course, streamed. And check it out on WebWeeklyLive.com. Gary Crispin, getting you ready for the next big ball game.
Go. Yeah, welcome back. Jamie Spencer along with Paul McGinn. 2:39 left to go in the fourth quarter. The game is tied, 42-42. My phone's blowing up. Your phone's blowing up. This is all exciting. Yeah, someone just called and said, hey, what's the score? I'm just like, I'm busy. Girardi will kick it short again. Ball's going to be taken by the big fella right there. Tries to get across the field.
Holding!
He's knocked down right at the 45-yard line. Everybody's yelling and screaming. Oh, this is intense. This is too nuts. Too nuts.
Hey, playoff atmosphere here tonight. Yep. We knew that coming in. Okay, mm-hmm. Both these teams will be in the District 2 6A playoffs. Okay, possible play district championship game preview here tonight. And Williamsport has looked good, bad, whatever. But here we are at a tie ball game with 2.5 minutes to go.
Two wide receivers to the bottom of the screen. Go with the tailback up the middle. He picks up five, gets to about midfield, Paul. Brings up second down in 6. 2:20 left to go. Tie ball game, 42-42. Whoever took the under on this one, you're in trouble.
Excuse me.
You were talking about the casino, you said. So. I thought you would get this. Here we go. Play action. Quarterback's going to roll out. It's going to throw it, and it is complete. Knocked out of bounds. It's going to be a nice play. Good play call. I'll tell you, that quarterback is no joke. Williamsport fans, of course, need to want to hold.
Yeah, you know, the quarterback really likes to roll out to the right. I would think about maybe bringing a blitz or a spy or someone in to contain him and keep him from rolling out to the right, because he's very comfortable doing that. And I think it'll throw him off and throw off the whole play, you know?
Touchdown, Hankins. Ties it up, 42-42. Just under 2 minutes to go. Right up the middle, and he smacked! Big time play by number 10, Jackson.
And number 31, I believe, with the initial stuff.
Stebbins has been pretty quiet tonight, but again, that's a great offensive line for Del Valle. Touchdown, Hankins. Ties it up, 42-42. Just under 2 minutes to go. Right up the middle, and he smacked! Big time play by one wide receiver to the right. One will go to the left. Backs are in the eye. Gonna go run right up the middle. And Dickey trips him up. Short game. Gonna be third down, and we'll call it 9, Paul. As it looks like they're going to take a timeout. Timeout on the field. Timeout Del Valle, 42-42, 108 left to go in the game. I need some horsepower.
Hey, what's going on? It's Jake and Ben over at Horsepower Harley-Davidson. We're out here on the sales floor checking out the pink tags and the pink balloons. Ben, tell them what's going on.
Right now on our pre-owned inventory, we have the pink tag sale going on.
What that means is that Horsepower Harley-Davidson will be donating to $25 to Catherine Kander Lundy Women's Breast Health Center right here in our backyard at Williamsport Divine Providence Hospital. Come on down and check out these big sales and big event. Horsepower Harley-Davidson, 1910 East 3rd Street.
So come out and see us.
Hi, welcome to Great Clips. Just walk right in, no appointment necessary. To save more time, download our free Great Clips app. Here at Great Clips, we have personalized haircut notes, so you'll leave here feeling like nothing less than a millionaire.
So come visit us today at the Loyal Plaza on the Golden Strip.
Get your head in the game here at Great Clips. It's gonna be great.
Yeah, welcome back. Delaware Valley, 108 left to go in the game, 42-42. Score is tied. Del Valle with the ball. Three wide receivers go to the top. We got a flush out to the left. Oh! And he's hit right as he throws. Oh. It's complete over the middle. And he's knocked down. It's going to be good enough for the first down. Shucks. Shucks. That's going to stop the clock to move the change with 59 seconds. And Paul, wow. That was a great play by the defense. Great play by the offense. First down, Del Valle.
Man, our defensive end, I mean, was literally a second away from probably stripping the quarterback, causing some kind of turnover, but at least hitting him, knocking him with a sack.
Clock is running. Tailback give, and he slips. I'll tell you, that kid just finds a way to get yards.
Yeah, always falling forward.
Yes.
He's not even that big.
No, he's awkward.
Get it.
No huddle. Backs are in the eye again. Going to give it to their tailback. Tailback is still on his feet. He's going to run in. He's going to get in for the end zone. Touchdown. Touchdown, Del Valle. Touchdown, Del Valle, with 24 seconds left on the clock, Paul.
Man,
happened all
times.
Night, man. Happened all night. Like you said, buddy, he just ran right up the gut. Right up the gut. So the Williamsport Millionaires, bud, all they can do here is hope for a miss and maybe make some spectacular play on the special teams, but wow.
Hey, we've seen it. I think, you know, they're probably going to do some kind of pooch kick or squib kick. I'd put all of my athletes there ready to handle the ball.
Kick is up. Kick is good. So with 24 seconds left in the game, the Warriors score. They take a lead, 49-42. We're going to go ahead and take a quick timeout. Let's hear a little more from Cups.
Did you hear that? It sounds like great new deals at Cups, your vacuum center. We offer new and used vacuums from all of the best brands, including Kirby, Shark, Dyson, Electrolux, Oreck, Hoover, and many more. Got an old vacuum that needs repair? Trust that our service repair technician will get it working like new again. For bags, belts, filters, repairs, and sales, trust Cups Vacuum Center located at 1001 Washington Boulevard in Williamsport.
Welcome back, Delaware Valley High School, where they have taken the lead on homecoming, 49-42. What a ball game here, Paul. Williamsport has 24 seconds left to go. See what happens, but man, kid just running right up the middle. Unbelievable. And, made some plays.
He's done it all night, too. Part of that is, you know, terrible tackling. The other part of it is great blocking on the Warriors' part and just some tough running. My goodness.
Two good teams. Two
impressive.
Really good teams. Now, Williamsport was a little flat coming out of the gate.
Yep.
And they'll have a chance. Maybe we'll see these guys again. You never know. But, again, some of the powerhouses here in 6A. Don't let that record fool you. 4-2. The two losses have been against big-time teams.
Yeah. Del Valle trailing the Millionaires in the playoff point standings, however that works, by 260-some coming into this week. Even with a win here, that's going to be still 100 shy.
There's a kick. It's going to return. And he's knocked out of bounds. Clock will stop with 20 seconds left. So,
one timeout.
Walker and company. Potts, Hankins, Jackson's in the ball game. One timeout, as he said, 20 seconds. So, I think smart play. We'll try to get a nice chunk and see what happens.
Clock stops to move the chains. So you want to make sure that each play is 10 plus yards. All right. Still have the whole field. You got to hurry to the line of scrimmage. Clock it down so you're not using timeouts. Hey, it's improbable, but it's not impossible, my friend.
And it looks like...
imagine that. They call it now.
Yeah. Everybody's joking, Paul, because there was a play early where they broke the huddle. They had 12 guys in the huddle, and it resulted in a touchdown, and everybody in the stands were yelling it
no
off. There's 12 guys, no flag, touchdown. And right there, you know, they caught him for cheating.
Well, I'll tell you, a lot of great football games. You're seeing it at webweeklylive.com. And, of course, all the segments are sports show and more. And thanks to the folks right behind us, Cochran's Automotive here in West 3rd Street. Big sponsor and folks that stand behind all the broadcasts on webweeklylive.com and PA Sports Live. We thank them for their support. Local folks, thank them when you see them because it takes a lot to get these games on and, of course, streamed. And check it out on webweeklylive.com. Gary Crispin, getting you ready for the next big ball game.
First and five for the Williamsport Millionaires. As Hankins is going to try to get some things going. 20 seconds left to go. Williamsport trails by 7, 49-42. Hankins drops back, tries to get, going to flush out of the pocket, going to throw, has a man open. It's incomplete. Jackson was the intended receiver. That would have picked up a nice chunk of yardage there, Paul, but null and void, 12 seconds. Second down and five for the Williamsport Millionaires.
Yeah, Warriors in a prevent defense. They have three guys, you know, 30 yards down the field all the way back trying to prevent the big play. Remember, Williamsport, you got one timeout. The whole middle of the field's wide open. You can get the ball to a playmaker and something can happen, but man, just nothing doing there on first down.
Second down and five, but that really doesn't matter. Ball is spotted at the 35-yard line. Hankins drops back, going to throw it, and it is incomplete. Incomplete. Young man will take a knee right there at half field.
Interception.
And, tough. You hate to see that. And, you know, the Williamsport Millionaires got to keep their head up, bub. Lot of football left.
Yeah.
Lot of football left.
Hey, you made a long trip on a Saturday afternoon, playing the 4 o'clock game on a Saturday afternoon, and in a hostile environment against a very, very, very good team. And you come away on the short end of the stick.
Yep.
No big deal. Keep your heads held high.
And Del Valle will take the knee, and that's an impressive victory for Del Valle, who will move to 5-2 on the year. As, yep. Jamie Spencer, Paul McGinn, and wow, what a great ball game here tonight in Delaware Valley. Came to play. Williamsport maybe got off to a sluggish start, but 49-42, made some valiant comebacks, tale of two halves, like all kinds of like drama going back and forth, like kind of a ping pong match. Came up short on the stick, so you got to rebound and see what happens. But kudos to Delaware Valley. They played well. They always found a way to answer.
Yeah,
tough
absolutely.
Game.
And you see some frustration here on the sideline for the Millionaires. And I get it. Look, I was a very passionate player.
Yep.
No matter what sport it was I was playing. And you never really – you get caught up in the moment, okay? Coach has got to do a good job here of making sure that these guys
– teach them.
Keep their heads held high, okay? This is a great learning experience because, look, if both these teams win out the rest of the year, and it's very possible that that happens – we'll be right back here for a district championship game, okay? Maybe even hosting a district championship game. Who knows? But this rematch will happen, and there's things that can be taken from this game that are going to make these guys better. Absolutely.
Got to give a shout-out to Horsepower of Harley-Davidson. New pickup for us, and great right there on the Golden Strip. A lot of good things happening for them. I'm not really a Harley guy. I mean, I can wear the leather. I can sport it. But at the same
yeah.
time, brother, it's great to have them aboard. A lot of good things happen. It's just replay tonight just because, unfortunately, sometimes you get out in the middle of nowhere
yeah.
and you don't have reception. But it is what it is. Great instant classic. There was some plays, the Potts play that got called back for it, but I just cannot wait to see that just because it was so impressive. Williamsport's got to keep their heads up because they played a great game. Like you said, it was a weird atmosphere. 4 o'clock,
yep.
Saturday afternoon game. Yeah, in the bus, at least 3 hours to get out here in the middle of nowhere. They didn't have their cell phones. You know, they can't get hyped because they had no cell phone. See where I'm going there? No cell phone.
Yeah.
But it is what it is. But kudos to Del Valle. So, exciting game. We're going to go ahead and wrap things up. We got a lot of busy weeks coming ahead. We might even head up to Jersey Shore starting next week. Follow the Jersey Shore Bulldogs. So, stay tuned to Facebook. Stay tuned to our PA Sports Live website, webweeklylive.com. Jamie Spencer, Paul McGinn, and the rest of the group, thank you very much for tuning in. We'll see you next time. Final score, final time, 49-42. Williamsport comes up short of the stick.
Again, thank you very much, Horsepower Harley-Davidson, proud sponsor now of PA Sports Live, and doing some nice things there. this whole month of October, pink tag sale, can't say it enough. I want to make sure the public knows, because for every sale there at Horsepower Harley-Davidson, they're going to donate $25 for breast cancer awareness.
Now, that's good stuff, and special thanks to all of our sponsors. Just, you do a great job. Thank you. Can't say enough about that. So, again, thank you. For Jamie, Paul, everybody, we'll catch you later. Thank you. Little option play that time. Pots, another cutback. Oh, man, another cutback. He's going to go to the outside. Does he have enough horsepower?
He does.
And he does. Touchdown, Trayson Pots.
Made the Wildcats and some pressure as well on the quarterback.
Third down and four. Watkins, quick throw that time. Gets it out to his playmaker, Williams. Williams is going to pick up enough for the first down and then some. He's on his way. He's got one man to beat, and he's still on his feet. There he goes. He's at the 30, the 20, the 10, and he's in for a touchdown. Kick. Walker's going to field it on the fly at the 30-yard line.
Makes
the
first guy miss.
Going to set up the wall. Here he goes. Gets to the outside. And he's got a couple of them. Marty Nuck and a guy around. How would you like to try to get around him? Ellen Walker's going to walk in. First down, so it brings up second and short. Kavanaugh up the middle. It's nice trap play. Kavanaugh is going to kick it to the outside. Has a lot of running room. Still on his feet. He's at the 30, and he's just got some speed. Here comes Potts, left-hand side. He's going to kick it. Wow, what a shift. He's
gone. Go all the way.
He's all the way. How about that block? Motion out to the right. They're going to swing it to him. Hunter Webb gets a few blocks. Going to cut it across the air. There he goes. He's got the rail set up. And he gets to the first down. Still on his feet.
He's gone.
Hunter Webb with a touchdown. Wow.